23rd. We'll start with three sets of minutes that I hope we can get through. Mike and I were here for the regular meeting on October 2nd and a, was it a budget workshop on October 6th?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So I looked them over and I was fine with those minutes based on, I may have made a non-substantial change. One of those was Cory.
No, they Cory'd one of them, right?
Cory, yeah. So, we good with them? Okay, and Jody, you and I had the 16th last week.
Yes.
And I was fine. I did make
I know.
Contract. What, did
Well,
here?
You changed your mind.
During the course of the meeting?
Yeah.
So we decided not to do it?
Well, no, you decided not to do it at first, but then after, later on, it made a lot of sense and you passed it.
So did you change the minutes then to reflect that?
No, that's how the minutes read.
Oh, so later on in the minute it shows up again. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I was wondering, maybe I should just take it out and put later there.
Or just put, you can, here's what, the other thing you can do is put the square brackets and put discussed again later in the minutes.
Yeah.
So that alerts the reader that
yeah.
there's something else. Because you're right, I mean, that's how it,
yeah.
I had forgotten that, but all I remember is that I thought we had agreed to the copier.
Yes, you have.
I do. We're never not agreeing.
Yeah, well, that's right. We actually have to review the contract itself, which
yes,
is in here. So. All right, so Jody, are we okay with those minutes? Yes, so by consensus,
yes.
All three sets have been given the okay. Community input, we have some, we have a distinguished guest. So.
I don't know what the procedures are nowadays.
Well, we're going to do community input. We're going to do department, you can come on up.
Okay.
We do department heads after we check in with
okay.
the.
Okay, I don't want to cut you guys off.
No, no.
Nice to see you out.
Nice to see Suzanne.
Now, do you remember about a month ago I was in?
Mm-hmm.
Because the Boy Scout Council had to have your signature
okay.
on a permission to do a project. Well, unfortunately, they turned this project down.
I thought I heard that. That's somehow.
Yes.
I don't know how, but
it's kind of a technicality, I guess. And
yeah.
you can explain it more than I can. But basically, I guess, seeing as a town thing that we've been doing, the invasive species thing, it kind of, they wanted something new. So he is now. The committee talked about it last month at our meeting, and we made a couple of suggestions, and he's got an idea of what he could do. And he's going to present those to you right now. Hopefully you can sign off on them.
All right, well, that's wonderful. And I've forgotten your name.
Luke Conroy.
Luke Conroy. Nice to see you, Luke.
Thank you. Yes,
and you are an Eagle Scout? Or you're about, you're trying
I'm
to
trying
become?
Trying to become an Eagle Scout.
Okay.
And I'm from Troop 313, Berwick.
Okay.
So last month I was working on a proposal that involved the removal of the invasive plants. And then when I got everything through, I wrote the proposal and submitted it. They rejected it because they thought it was more of a maintenance project and they don't allow that
mm-hmm.
because it's been done before and they want you to do something new. So what I created a new proposal I discussed with Al and I came up with perhaps creating a kiosk and a bench near the Greenview Drive end of Scoutland to put at one of the trailheads there. And the kiosk would have a map of all the trails so that people who were walking or doing activities there could clearly see all of the trails and where to go. And then there would also be just a spot for announcements or other information that other events from the community or people, community members can post ideas. And then I would have a bench. And then here's my proposal that I've written. Starts here, and this would be done in the spring of next year, 2018.
You just have this one problem.
And then, there's more in the next pages.
Would the kiosk and the bench be inside the gate, inside the gate?
Probably inside.
Okay.
Yeah, we had talked about that with the Conservation Commission, and when you go in by Greenview, you come to a crossroad.
Pretty quickly, yeah.
With the orchard being cleaned up. And,
yeah.
And everything on this side of it, the right-hand side belongs to Wentworth.
and the other side, I think, is Mark Kuchar.
Oh, I see.
You get into Scout Land, you get past the intersection, which is probably right there in that corner, would be a good spot. Although, you know, the possibility still, I mean, I don't know if we have talked to Greenview, or to Wentworth, to say it may be, you know, right there in the entrance, people can keep a closer eye on it. You know, because when you put something out in the woods, sometimes they tend to feel the vandalism problems.
So I'm just gonna read this out loud so that fellow board members can hear it. So here's the project description and benefit. This service project is going to be the construction of a bench and a kiosk with a trail map of Scotland, the conservation area in which they will be placed. Currently, there are no signs nor a map of the trails, so I believe this will be helpful to all those who use or would like to use the trails. The kiosk and bench will be placed near one of the entrances to the area so that it will be easily seen. Scotland is a conservation area in the town of Rollinsford, New Hampshire. There are some little maps, they're kind of light, but I can't see.
The document that I have to do it on is set up that way, and we only have those two pictures, and so it's tricky to form that, so I'm sorry.
So my age of eyes can't, I can tell that there's something there. All right, tell your project will be helpful to the beneficiary, which could be town. This project is helpful because it could draw more people from the community into the conservation area. A kiosk with a map of the trails would more easily direct community members to places to walk, exercise, and enjoy the outdoors. The bench will provide a place to rest for all those who are using these trails. And you plan to do this in spring of 2018, according to this. And the people that you need in your project, 5 to 10, are going to be people that you recruit.
Yeah, most likely from my course head crew, other peers from my school, and then also I'm going to try to get peers from Marshwood High School to do it, because some of them are from Rollinsford, they're from the area.
Is there anything that the town, that you would be looking for the town to provide, other than you know, assent and support in that way?
No, I think everything else I would be able to do my own.
I'll let you take a peek at that too, if you'd like to see that.
As part of the projects, is that?
Pardon?
As part of the projects, I look and show that we would do it. He has to recruit everyone to work, and he has to manage and crew and all of us. It's important.
It's a good skill, project management.
Yeah, exactly, that's the whole idea.
Leadership and project management.
Wonderful, thank you for choosing Rollinsford.
And you're a student at Marshwood?
I'm a student at Noble High School.
Noble, that's right, you said you were.
And then my mom teaches at the Rollinsford Grade School. I go to church at the First Parish Federated Church in South Berwick, and then a lot of people from Rollinsford. So that's how I got connected.
That's nice, thank you. That's great.
Big family is for partners. Lucina.
Charlie.
I like the idea of the kiosks, because I've been known in the local.
Yeah, if you know, you know, but if you don't know,
right.
It would be nice to be able to offer that to visitors.
And I think the OHFB club has a pretty good map of that area.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I'm sure they would help by getting a printout of that or getting a copy of that somehow.
Yep. And also, if you had electronic, a digital copy of whatever map or trails you devised, we could also put that on the website. You know, as long, you know, if you've got it in a digital format as well. That could be helpful. And I'm sorry, Al, did you say the Conservation Commission has met and reviewed this? Did you say that?
Not the new proposal. We met because we knew that he had got turned down, and he had thrown a couple of ideas at me. So I brought those to the Conservation Commission, and we threw it around, and the kiosk was very, very acceptable, and they thought that was a real good idea. At one time, he was thinking about cleaning up. Down by the river, there's a big circle where they have fires.
Yes,
and he thought that was a Boy Scout thing, but that is really some kids go in there once or twice a year and have a bonfire, and anyway, it's just very illegal. And we said no, we don't want to encourage anything over there. So we want to come up here closer to the end, and you know, the commission thought that would be very handy to have that map there. And look, like you said, you know, there'd be a poster board there, so people could post up on it.
Yeah, the trails aren't marked, right? There's no actual.
There's some markings.
Are there?
Yeah, the OHRV called that markings.
Okay. You indicate that on your map too. That'd be helpful.
Yep.
Do we have any other questions or comments? Any objections?
Thank you.
Something we should worry about, or are we ready to sign the dotted line?
Yeah.
I will entertain a motion. So moved that we accept Eagle Scout Service Project proposed by Luke Conroy. Do I have a second? Have you seconded it? Any questions or discussions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Wonderful, congratulations. Do we have to, where's, do we have to sign anything?
If you could just write a letter, there's not a specific part of the workbook, so just write a letter saying that Luke Conroy has permission. Sorry?
Write the scary moment?
Yeah, that would be fair.
Okay.
That's all right.
You'll have to give us a minute or two.
While we're doing the letter, maybe I guess something I will just throw out to you. We met last Thursday, and we've been trying to get going on the invasive plant thing. And we have got a date. Our forester, Charles Marino, will be taking and getting a crew, 3 to 4 people, professionals that will be going in this year. In the past, we've used prisoners, and we've done, right now, we've got a lot of them cleaned up around the front, you know, the top, around the sort of upfield area. But the rest of them are pretty much spread out over the whole scout land, so it's going to take some people to know what they're doing.
Yeah.
But we are looking for volunteers.
I saw an email about it, didn't go on.
Yeah, it's on the web, I think. I think Tia put it on the web for us. And basically, it's going to be on the 30th, no, that's the 31st of October, which is a Tuesday. And 8:30 in the morning, we're hoping to collect a few people, and we could probably put a couple of volunteers with each one of these experts, and hopefully we can clean out a bunch of this stuff. Pretty much until, I'm guessing, most of the day, I must think.
Okay.
I would get most of the day.
People are meeting where?
Over at Greenville.
Right out there at the trailhead there? 31st?
Yeah, double check that, pretty sure.
Oh, it is a Tuesday, I just want to see if I'm, I think, pressing on the calendar.
Yeah, the more people we get over there, the better we'll be, and get these things cleaned up for the year, and we missed last year. We've also, because last year we did that thing around the Turcot field, we actually went in and took a lot of invasive species out. Well, now to keep it up, we have to mow this every year, this edge. So we have found someone that will do it, but surprisingly, it's quite expensive.
We know all about mowing and how much it costs.
We got two prices, and the guy that we did not pick was a lot higher than the one we picked, so we may want to talk at some point. But anyways, the guy wants $1,500. It's a day's work. So
just to
we're going to pay for that. You know,
yeah.
We're already committed. But we're thinking maybe in the future, where you guys are getting paid for that field, maybe we might offset some of the cost with that.
When they're up there, find out what kind of machinery they're using, too. Well, how large it is, because we've been,
I don't know,
kicking around, maybe purchasing something for the town. So we don't keep hiring them whenever the year.
It needs like a brush hog.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It's called a brush hog.
Yeah, but is it giant, like a full size, regular, normal one that goes on the side of a truck, or is it?
I would say it's not one tractor.
Yeah.
If it's like the state uses, it usually has an arm that they can move, and the Camry, the guy's name is Dave Camary.
Okay.
And he's the one that we found that we're doing. And he went and looked at it, and Reno, I think, is the guy you got going?
Had.
He had. Yeah, he's not doing it anymore. We were trying to,
because he came
struggling
in
to find.
He gave us a price of, well, it's one $2,800, the other guy wanted 15, so obviously we want for 15. But, you know, maybe somebody you may be interested in using for work.
I think we probably would like to talk to him at least.
I'm sorry, I really
we found someone, Al's got someone who does, let's say, roadside mowing, for lack of a better term right now. That's a pretty good price. Well, better than what we, more reasonable than perhaps what we've been hearing. So he's going to pass on the information so next year we can.
Okay, very good.
George.
Well, here's my button. To whom it may concern, at the Select Board meeting of October 23rd, 2017, the board unanimously approved Luke Conroy's proposal to install a kiosk and bench at the Scoutland Conservation Area Trailhead. The board thanks Luke for his offer to improve our conservation area, and we wish him the very best for this endeavor.
Perfect.
That's it.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you again.
Do you need a copy of that or anything?
You can. truly, maybe not, but if you made a copy, we'll file it, but I think we're good. I mean, it's recorded in the minutes.
Yeah.
Is the secretary wanting us to have?
Well, we can make a copy and I could put those in the minutes.
We could.
Almost like that way you'll have it. Now, you make two, or watch me do.
We can make one, we can make two.
There we go, yes. One extra, I think that was longer.
I'll just take the one.
No, you're gonna call it. We have the meeting. But in case you missed it, like I said, we are gonna be doing the invasive species October 31st, Tuesday. Anybody wants to come in and give us a hand?
In the morning?
8:30 in the morning, we're gonna start.
Okay.
And we'll have a professional crew of at least three to five people. And hopefully a few volunteers can work with them.
Is it on our website? Have you written something?
We did have it on our website. Lorraine contacted Tia.
And they posted it to the Captain's page and all the other things that are.
You mean the page I can't see?
So I guess we're all set.
Except for that copy. So thank you all for coming in. Luke, nice to meet you. Best of luck to you with this project and your.
It came from Tia's site to Tamara's site, so when it goes from Tamara's site to someone else's site, I get blocked.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
We'll see you now.
Good luck.
I mean, y'all, if you need anything. If you need anything.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Thank you, appreciate that.
Community input?
First of all, George, I love your enthusiasm about all the stop signs. My concern with that is you go around to other cities and towns and they have not done them all yet. Is there a, and I'm just looking at.
So before you ask George, this is our meeting. You can make a comment.
No, I'm just saying, thank you, George, for doing that.
Okay.
Before you go through all of that to purchase the signs, is there any other need somewhere else for the money that you would be putting in for the signs at this time? Because we went through Manchester and everything else and found that they have not upgraded at theirs either, so.
Well, you know, everything is fine until some regulatory agency says, you know what, you haven't changed your signs, you're gonna have to do them within the next month and a half, you know? So we know it's a standard, we know it's the USDOT standard. We've had that in our budget all along, and so we keep making some baby steps.
Okay.
We're not doing, as far as I know, this is just in next year's budget.
Okay.
Any other?
There it is.
We haven't even gotten there yet, exactly. Any other community input? All right, department heads. So I'm gonna start. Well, we might as well start with folks right here. George, you were here. Did you want to talk to us? You just here to?
I just get a couple of POs until.
Yep. That's fine.
Yeah, you thought of the truck inspections.
All right.
It's not a complete.
Sorry.
Move to accept purchase order 978 to the city of Dover under the highway department for truck inspections of all three trucks for, at this moment, $150.
Second.
Any discussion?
So this will bring all of our trucks in compliance, or no, we still want outstanding?
You've been out. So all the trucks needed to go.
Right, I knew that.
Our little truck is back.
Yeah.
Our international is at a place being fixed.
And they had one part that they had added in Dover that he didn't leave the price on yet.
And the third truck hasn't even been looked at yet.
$50 for one inspection, the small inspection is $100.
Guess they won't ask you how the winter prep is going on tomorrow. We'll wait for another meeting. I guess.
All right. So, just so you know, I mean, we're happy to approve this. We're happy to know what, you know, what you're up to. We did say that purchase orders under certainly 200 did not have to come by here. So. Okay. All right. So I'll call a question. All those in favor say aye.
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 Okay, I'm going to purchase order 977 to Morton Salt for two loads of road salt, not to, for up to $4,000.
You want to?
Second.
Any discussion? I will just say, or ask, that I hear that we're getting this at the price that we just negotiated, which is $5 per ton less, right about, so it's at the $53 price, that's good news. So let's put $4,000 here.
People that guess the weather, predict the weather, or write, it looks like we might have a mild.
They should fill this out, that's being posted.
So that's a good start.
La Nina coming up on speed.
Well, we haven't had any really sustained fall weather yet, I don't think, so. All right, we'll try not to jinx it. Are we ready to call a question? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
The order for purchase order is signed, I usually keep them in the folder for Caroline. Other departments like to keep them for themselves, I'm meeting to Caroline later, are you happy with me just already getting the folder for Caroline?
That's fine.
Okay.
So you can go ahead and do what needs to be done with regard to those two. Anything else, George? Yeah, you can give them to Mike, so.
Oh, so we haven't scheduled it yet, we're gonna schedule the next meeting, next, probably not this week, but the week after next, I think, just gonna make sure everyone's available. Are there any meetings that, I mean, rather, any evening that doesn't work for you, the first week in, on the last night, October 1st, we're still there for them? So if we met on the second, which is a Thursday night, would that work for you? Okay. It would probably be, it would be 6 o'clock, so, we'll try to. All right. I'll send up another. How is everything going so far? So far, so good, lots to take in, I know, so.
George was with us on Friday when we did the inspection of culverts.
Oh, good.
With Boyle Tanner and Parker.
Yeah.
So that was, I think, helpful to, you know, hear exactly what they've done and.
Have they finished down there?
They're done, this is the final inspection, the only paving's done, no, this was.
I haven't gone down.
This was the complete, this was the, not the substantially complete, the complete complete. And the only item that Boyle Tanner's gonna try to figure out a way to manage it is just, is reseeding. With some piece of grass at the lower mill that washed out the first time around, so they just wanna make sure that this next go around takes. Everything else, Boyle Tanner done a pre-inspection with a punch list, and Parker taking care of all the other items. So it looked good, it looked good. All set, thank you so much, George. So we have our two chiefs, I think, you were here first, Bob, right? I think so.
Thank you.
It's hard not to let anyone else go first, I think, the last of them.
Okay. Purchase order number 1309, made up to Quality Response Systems, I'd like to purchase three additional adult CPR AED pads. We actually had to use one over the weekend for someone on the Foundry Street, and it'd be nice to have a couple in reserve. So, pads are $65 each, shipping is $20 for a total of $215, and we'll take that out of our uniform account.
Move purchase order number 1309, Quality Response Systems for three adult AED pad cartridges for a grand total of $215.
Second.
Discussion?
So you all actually had to do it, you got their, was it a 911 call, or?
Yeah, it was a 911 call, and the officer got there and had to administer the.
I guess they're a little closer than.
Everybody kinda was involved in that one last night. They were going to the fire, to PD.
All right, any other comments or questions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, purchase order number 1311, Amazon.com, or reimbursement between me Part of our long-term goal with our firearms is to attach flashlights to them. So we're not doing this thing here with two hands and a flashlight and whatnot. So our project now and our survey now is to buy two flashlights and two holsters for those firearms, let the two fire instructors use it, play with it, do whatever you need to do with it for the next couple of months. And starting in 2018 and 2019, we'll start cycling through the department to add those units to our existing firearms. And we have money in the account for that, so it's 1311@amazon.com, uniform account. The flashlights are $125 each, and the holsters are $150 each, for a total of $550.
Move to accept purchase order 1311 to Amazon.com to reimburse Chief Duchesne for light flashlights and holsters for a total of $550.
Second. Good. So I have a question. So it's not the revolver or gun that has to be changed, it's the attachment on it, or it's the holster.
It's the holster that needs to be. The holster has to be enlarged because now you have to room in there for the flashlight.
Yeah.
Fit in there as well.
Yeah. Okay.
So it's just a bigger holster.
Just what you need, more pound.
More big stuff.
Yeah.
How often do we replace your sidearms?
About 15 years.
Every 15 years?
About 15 years.
Never mind.
We still
okay, there are now models that have them like built in underneath. You can buy a factory installed, you don't have to. But if you're
These firearms are fine. They'll last us for
okay.
years to go. So.
How much is a sidearm?
Well, it depends on what you want to get. These here are probably
something like those.
About $600.
Okay. Just curious.
All right, the best that you can get it at Amazon.
Well, that's the attachment. That is the attachment. But you can probably get them. Yeah, you probably can. That's good. All right. Are we ready to call a question? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. I've already forgotten. Can you get them back, Chief?
Yes.
I
trimmed them.
That's actually a good system. I like that.
Yeah. Apparently, we found over the weekend that apparently we had some type of a homeless encampment behind Petco over by Dover Bowl. Apparently, there was a campfire or something like that, and the fire department had to respond over the weekend and whatnot. There's all kinds of trash and whatnot up there. So we might want to contact the building inspector, code enforcement officer, have him go up there, take a look at it, and contact the property owner and see what he can do about getting the trash and garbage that's removed. If not, then it might behoove us to have our highway guys go up there and get it out of there. At some point, the property owners don't do that. Correct.
So the encampment itself is not currently active?
I have not personally been up there, but...
Not as of 8 o'clock last night when Officer Dover PD found an individual there with a campfire going, and the Rollins from PD showed up, and we went there and we extinguished it. The individual was there, the PD is aware of who he is, but they've got it set up with mattresses, couches, regular little encampment there. So we removed some of the stuff. But if it comes down to it, might be something George could go over there and just make it go away. It would probably behoove us. Because, yeah, it's starting to accumulate.
How far back from the...
Oh, it's right. It's right off the paved. There's a dirt road that goes out back for 400 feet into this area, right along the wood line.
These are adults, no minors.
As far as I know.
No minors, yeah. I think the one we encountered the other night was an adult.
Okay. The only question I ask is that someone said to me over the weekend that there was minors in the mill building trying to stay warm at 5 a.m. and they were removed. And they said that they were going over to the school. And so I said, well, I gave them your email and phone number and said that they were going to follow up.
So who said that? Who was going to
cleaning the lady that cleans the building? I happened to run into
So you can walk into the mill, the mill's not.
They open it up, but people go in, I have walked my dogs many times, people go in and out, but working, you know, like yarders and whatever, so the building is open.
And so they, so she was concerned as a mom, I ran into her later that day, and she was concerned as a mom for the minors, like, is being in the warm, that warm place more safe than being in their home? And I said, well, it's time to reach out to the police, I don't, I wasn't there, I can't remember.
That school's not open.
Yeah, they would be able to get to the school, right, it was not.
And even then.
When you mentioned the camp, I was like, oh, yeah, those two correlate at all.
So, so what seems to be the better approach, to have Tom contact the property owner to remove it, or?
Well, then, what Washington's on Rawls, I mean, incur the expenses unless we absolutely have to.
Yeah, okay.
So, you know, give the property owner 30 days or else we'll do it, but then we're going to bill you.
Bill, okay.
So.
Sounds good. All right, anything else?
A couple things.
Okay.
Just as a reminder, trick or treat is next Monday, 5 to 8 PM. And I've scheduled the next coffee with the chief for Saturday, November 4th, 9/11. And the last item that I have is I received a letter of resignation from a department officer this evening, Officer Casey Mulligan. His commitment to his full-time job at the Navy Yard right now does not allow him to participate in the needed training that we're having monthly. And he's not willing to work enough shifts to be able to stay fresh with the job. So after speaking with him, he just felt it the best that, you know, rather than get to the point where he gets in trouble because he's missing so much, that he just assumed he resigned at this point and he'll go out.
How long has he been with us?
He's been with us for 11 years. He's a Rawls from town. What I'd like to do is forward to you his name and address, maybe the select board can just sign a letter saying, you know, thanks for letting me in service, wish you well, whatever the place might be. I'm sure you appreciate that.
Absolutely. And what about a replacement?
We're not going to worry about it until next year.
He's someone we want back, though, if circumstances
change. I told him, I said, if your circumstances change and any time in the future, you know, as far as I'm concerned, you have a spot here, so.
All right. I'm sorry to hear it. And just so you know, and actually the public, the board, as a reminder, the board last week, in your absence, Michael.
Yes, I didn't read last, I didn't read the other.
We decided to cancel next Monday's meeting.
I guess I'm going trick-or-treating.
So you can go trick-or-treating with Elizabeth.
All right.
Trick-or-treating with Zach and Zoe.
Figure out a costume now.
And I'll just watch Monday Night Football. Or something like that.
Or you can come down to town hall and give all candy here.
There you go.
Is that what you do?
That we have a volunteer who comes in and she'll sit the front door. We open the front door in case come into PD and do the trick or treat.
Oh, that's really wonderful. That's very nice.
And then we'll probably have 3 cars out that night. And if the kids approach any of the cruises, we give all candy and the cruises. Mm-hmm. Don't have them in the kids.
Oh, that's really sweet. That's great.
Yeah.
Nice. You have someone down at the bottleneck that happens.
Slockdown Circle. Stockdale. We have someone there just to keep the peace.
When my parents moved into Stockdale, like in 1995, they said, you've got to come over here.
Oh, it's nuts.
And it was unbelievable. Yeah. I think they had hash marks. They were counting. They were just so tickled. They had like almost 100 kids who came that night. This was in 1995.
It's worse.
Yeah, sure.
Much busier now.
Yeah.
So.
Oh yeah, it's a nice, it's
exactly.
A beautiful development. Yeah,
it's a drop off.
Absolutely, it's safe. Yeah, yeah.
Quick 60 pieces of candy.
Yeah, it's a drop
off. There's main plates out there, so I know you
have. I just have
they used to do it on Avril Brown's Road until
it
got busy.
Over on Church Street. So I didn't know if you know about that. And then, did we order the one for the compactor?
I don't think
I
gave it to you when you were going to speak with the members of the place of the order.
Okay, so that's a fair thing.
Yeah, but did you want to check with Chief to about the size of the replacement? Because you can probably do both at the same time. Is it the same kind of mirror?
It would be. It would be a convex mirror, but you would want
larger.
You want a larger one than 12 inches for the roadside.
Was the road 36?
Do we have it, or is it just completely gone?
I think they shattered it.
Oh, there is in the bracket.
Okay.
Is there a 2-foot one? I don't know if it's sufficient. Is there a 2-foot?
Yeah.
I can't read the dimensions.
Diameter 12, 18, 26, 30, and 26.
What do you think?
26. I thought it was a good size when they were four.
I thought it was 3-foot one.
2 feet probably, 20.
So 26.
26.
26.
26.
Okay.
Mostly to alert
the.
I can't
think of 3 foot. Anyone?
Buses or
walker or whoever.
The biggest issue is buses.
Yeah.
3 feet. Some buses.
Is that it?
That was it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Nice. And Chief Rutherford.
I do.
Lovely.
I had the arrangements made for that, but they kind of got changed. Circumstances outside of my control.
Yeah, I had some business.
Yes. Yeah, I was going to be here Thursday to give it to Caroline. So we ended up in Sanford. Pretty bad motor vehicle accident in Northborough and then in Dover. So we started at 2, we got out at 10:30. So yeah, long day. That's why we're there. Couple of POs first. First I have is number 1242. It's for the New Hampshire State Firemen Association. It's for the members that we have for their annual dues for the insurance coverage and whatnot that they are for. So it's going to be for the 22 members we have, totals $480 that can drive our association each month.
And that was
that's what came in.
Saw.
We saw all this. The envelope came in, but it didn't come in with a purchase order. So I'm like, it didn't look like.
Now you know it, because there it is. Well, I got an email today from Caroline. She says it should have been more than that. But she counted all the names that are on the forms. But there's deletions, people that have moved on. And there's a couple of additions. So
this is the net.
So that's basically the ballpark number we need to have sent to the state.
Perfect. I'll move purchase order number 1242, the New Hampshire State Firemen's Association for annual dues for the state association in the amount of $480.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Purchase order 1241 to Devin Duke's Monogram for department ball caps and polo shirts for a total of $579.78.
Second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Dover was going to undo their upgrade, but that's kind of slipped back a little bit.
Yeah.
So we've been working with it, with our other system, and it's been working out very well.
Did you want me? We
here last week?
No, I don't think so.
No.
You didn't want to meet with us, and I don't know if you do next tonight, or you said it was a personnel issue.
Well, it was not a specific issue, but overall encompassing issue. As a concern, I'm starting to see what here.
Well, whenever you're ready, do it tonight, or?
I'm just gonna, if you already got it, I was gonna meet with you and just.
So these are the only change.
Some of it's kind of reflected in there as to some of the things, but I can explain some of it.
So we do have, the board is working, I don't even want to say proposing, that's a little too formal. The board is working with a budget that has a 2% across the board, which would increase the chief stipend to 72.83, and the salaries line to 39,352.
So it was like a 2% bump over there?
2%, yes.
I'd like to see if it's 2% on top of that request.
2%.
I know, because the same thing happened last year when we gave you that. And I understand where we're heading, and you can see my little bit of explanation on why I'm requesting it. And there's been numerous times that have popped up in the last year or so where people just can't get it, because cost-wise. We'll be able to make a minimum wage and stand next to guys over 20 bucks an hour, giving you a little tough customer.
So help us then, because I don't think it's fully in our head. So someone who is on call when they do come out to serve, they're making, all I see is just the one salary line, so you know, we just say, okay, 2%.
Barely minimum wage. By the time the point system is allocated for the amount of attendance that the people have, we break that salary line in the quarters. Okay, so roughly 10 per quarter. Depending on how many calls we have, how many people attend, you earn a specific amount of points. So just a big part. And then you just take them points and divvy that up, and it comes out to, I think last year, the last quarter, we just barely squeaked in $100. $1 to $3 an hour. Because the point pretty much equates to an hour. And there's people that come in, say, just can't go not that rate. Not like the other day, we spent almost 10 hours in it, where they might have been missing their other work.
I was just going to ask you, so are they leaving their day jobs to come and do this?
We've had a few that have done that, and they can't.
Right, or these are people that have that aren't working or retired or mostly
the whole thing, all of that.
Okay.
But a lot of it is, you know, we may have people there, there's still a need for them to be there for hours, you know, like,
right,
who are you going to call on at 4 in the morning?
It's
going to be work at 7, right. So I have to start managing, all right, you got to go, but we're still requested to be there for whatever the needs are.
Right.
So it's becoming more and more of an issue. As before, they just say, I'll just call, I'll get to the report. It's come to the point that it just doesn't work as well as it used to. Not only that, just the pool is not there. And as you see on that training, like, I always had very good access. Of course, when I was teaching, I would draw an awful lot of my students into the program. That has started to curtail. But what I have tried to do, and I've made a contact with an ex-retired buddy of mine in the fire department who teaches at UNH, classes at UNH. He's already rounded up two people and sent them our way that are getting their EMS certifications and getting the fire service under. So we're planning on, we've had to interview one, we're going to interview the other, trying to add those onto our roles.
Is the Explorer program still a good feeder program or not?
Not as good as it was.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, we had numbers where we had to actually back it down. We never said no.
Right.
We had to set
one time, right?
Yeah, it just hit cyclic, and now we're on that down inside of that cycle. So that feeder program is there, but not as reliable as it was.
Mm-hmm.
The school program, again, the same way. The last few years that I was doing it, we always had 12 to 15 students. This year they have 7. So it's even harder to get those to come this way. Constantly looking and asking. The other thing is we're in competition with everybody around us. We've lost some of our explorers that have come to us, to our neighbor next door, because they can offer that $14 an hour salary. So where are you going to go?
It's undeniably true that little town of Rollinsford is facing the salary pressures that are all around us. You know, the unemployment is dropping. It's good for folks, but it makes it difficult for us, you know, to try to, we can't even compete. We're not competing.
No, and that's, and I know we are.
Based on what you're telling me.
Right, and the other thing that we have that kind of works for us is not only that, you know, the compensation end of it, is the fact that, you know, I bring people in, I interview them, I pull up my little list out of my desk drawer, there's almost 50 wounds on me that have gone through the Rollinsford Fire Department, their career someplace else in the local area. So that's.
That's a good thing.
If you come here and put your time in, we can get you some training, we can get you some experience, you can start your networking in, and I'm pretty well tied in with most everybody around here, so when it comes time for them maybe to sit down in front of an interview, I can say something to them, it's chief or whatever, some major name. So that list is, you know, factual that you do the job, this can get you there. So that's another way I try to reel them in.
So let's go back to that salaries line.
We can only reel them so long, until they.
They get off the hook.
Right, they get off the hook.
But that's, yeah, but that, you know.
I understand why, it makes sense, and it makes sense.
Why, so you have to.
I mean, it's the on-call model is still the model that works. I'm not suggesting a full-time department.
It works for you, but you know, I just don't know how long it's.
Yeah, how sustainable it is.
My biggest fear all the time is when the phone comes in, it goes and it's nobody there. It hasn't happened.
When what?
When there's nobody there, because it comes in, you go, and it hasn't happened yet. But that's just something that caused something buried in my back pocket.
So you don't know who's gonna show up?
There's some ways to try to alleviate some of that, get some conversations with some other chiefs in this program. You know, I'm there, you know, 86% of the time. Kevin and I went to the office at the top of that list and just tripped it way down. And there's other ways to guarantee that you're going to just have enough people to get the crew out. There's communities now that like pay people stipend, daily stipend, to make sure that they're available for whether it be 12 or 24 or a portion of a day. And you get 25, 30, 40 bucks a day to make sure you get the fire station.
Who else is managing an on-call fire department in our general radius?
I am here.
So I'm going to work.
Greenwood.
Matt Gary.
And even some of those are not totally on-call. I have people that are there. Some folks call fire department, their chief is there. He's compensating 30 something hours a week. Same with Elliot. So somebody's there. So we can just get on the road and get to take care of it.
Our towns like New Durham and Milton and Farm, are they
paid?
They're paid. No one calling anymore. We're all paid.
One or two people.
Yeah.
Just consider, you know, just people there.
But then they, so they have some paid staff,
some,
they have some on call.
Yeah.
So it's a composite of regular.
It's not like, you know, the larger cities are on this, I have 4 or 5, 10 guys on call.
Oh, sure. No, yeah.
But they'll have one or two. And then as a call comes in, they at least get started, and then they're not called, but augmented.
So the salaries you're requesting, 40. Were you saying more? Were you with?
I mean, not knowing where the town as a whole was going to go, I mean, that was the number that I wanted to start with. I know we ran into the exact same thing last year, because I requested something. Well, you're going to get this much anyway. Through the budget process, which it did. But I'm trying to stay ahead of the curve. And I mean, if you go over 2%, probably just about what I can do.
Well, it is. 2% takes you 39.3.
Yeah.
So.
I put that in not considering
any percentage
at the top. So, not
whatsoever. Okay. So, just a flat 40,000 would.
Without going, you know.
Yeah, you probably already said this, you missed it. With the point system currently, it breaks down to just about $8 an hour for most people, give or take a little fluctuation. What will the extra 15 or 17?
$1,400
change?
Versus there, maybe just continue continues to creep up a little bit. So I have a monthly meeting that can be saved in our communities that exist, and supports that. That shows that there's still some interest in having the support, and we're trying.
Right.
At least I can do that, and not say that they're slamming the door on me. Because like I said, I know for a fact there are less people next door because of that one thing.
So an on-call firefighter in Southfield could get $14 an hour?
$12 to $14 an hour. They have a point system, they do it the same way, but it's an hourly rate. I've seen that, witnessed it, you know, tomorrow, hey, we're going to be working with other people. Because it's a competition, you know, unfortunately it is. We all come together when there's an incident, but that initial, I mean, if it's something that's just our responsibility, we don't need a lot of people, at least we can make sure we get it out. We're going to fire, everyone's going to get anyway. But, you know, it's just some of the smaller things.
What's the minimum you would need on a crew for a traffic? Couple cars,
five people. Safely.
And you haven't missed that mark yet.
Put me on a Route 4. I want.
That's what I mean.
LA.
Yeah. I don't blame
them. I mean, it's
realistically, how many people actually show up?
Initially, if I can get three people on the first piece, I'm happy for me to start. Because it's like we had a discussion before. There's only like four of us on the town.
Yeah.
The other night we had a call, so it was myself, another gentleman that lives in Starkdale, and a guy on Silver Street. We were in the truck a little over 4 minutes. The other guys didn't get there till 10 minutes because they're calling themselves. All right, they're over, they're coming from Silver Street. We've had that discussion before in the town meeting. How few members actually live in our community that respond to that members. The members of this community supported by people from outside of them.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you use your point system, and they're there for 10 hours. I said, do you clock them in? So whether you're there for the guy that's there for 4 hours or 10 hours, their points are going to be different that day.
One guy can only be there 4 hours, he's going to earn his 4 points for the time he was in. The other guy's going to lose 10 points because he's been there for
a while. I wasn't sure if it was
per
call or per hour.
Just as an example, we started to Sanford, that was at 2. When we were up there until about 5, coming back, ran into a near head-on collision on Route 4 in North Berwick, so we requested to help them, so we were there for an hour, then while we were there, Dover had their building fire over on Littleworth Road, so we went from there to there. That's three different individual calls at three different individual set of times, so those points are in each one, because there's people that are coming and going. So that all gets logged in the site machine, and all that is to separate.
And I appreciate you putting all that information out on Facebook, on your Facebook page, and that's great for the town to see how busy you guys really have been.
Yeah, we tried. So.
It is distressing to think that, you know, we're only scraping together,
right,
you know, minimum wage. And, you know, again, based on, you know, what we see around us, how are we going to manage this? So, I mean, would you be amenable to, like, having some kind of strategic planning group working with you to think about options or, you know?
We could do something like that. I mean, I already have a whole bunch of things that we could look at.
You mean ideas?
Well, I think, though, what Suzanne may be, and I don't want to speak for Suzanne.
Even though you are.
What I think, I'm gleaning from this conversation. A strategic planning group may get you more buy-in, a broader swath of the community, right?
True.
So if it's just the four of us having a conversation, you know, and the few people that are here and the few people that are watching, you know,
yeah.
But if you can get, you know, people from different groups that don't necessarily come to meetings,
but have some,
might get more buy-in.
Right, exactly. It gets the information, just, you know, it diffuses it, disperses it a little bit more into the general community. It's not perfect, but you've got, you know, somebody lives over there, somebody lives over there, and, you know, they'll talk to the neighbor, and so it is helpful. So, you know, we might consider something.
Jody's after the rope, right? The exposure on social media now certainly helps.
We try to do that.
But you all are very, 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 very good.
All of our incidents, what goes on next? Yeah.
So, I'm just asking the question. But if it were $45,000, what, I'm trying to figure out how much raises it by.
You know, like up to, you know, 90-something an hour. It's very hard to tell exactly which increment, how much that actually turns back to what the rate would be. It's kind of sense.
Yeah, but I had no benchmark, so even that's.
Yeah, well, that's what I was asking about the 14-20. What does that really get you?
Yeah.
It's not a whole bunch, but my thought was, you know, I'm not going to come in here, you know, asking to break the bank, because I understand how that's going to work. Like I said, my reason for a lot of it was.
Everyone else does, I don't know why you should print it.
You're going to do the bad people.
Because I already did that, and I got some other things here I'm going to talk about with that.
I'm just, sometimes I just have to.
Well, see, the thing was before, we made a big stride, community did as a whole for our equipment needs, you know.
That was a big commitment.
Exactly right. And so I, and that, and we're going to take care of that, get all those things on the road, and the next one is going to be percent. So that's kind of cool. But I'm not going to keep steamrolling that stuff. And like I said, my thought is when I'm there and the budget comes through and I can sit in front of all the members on the monthly meeting night and say, this is who we are, this is what we asked for, this is what they're going to give us, they're supporting us. Rather than saying, no, no, no. And I know it's not a lot, but it really helps. And it gets in a positive frame of mind so they can really see that, that okay, we're working. A lot of the people that we have, in the last year, we've lost four people from our roles on our career someplace else. But they are still with us because they know where they got their start. They didn't forget where they came from. Some of them are loyal to me because they're where they are because of what's happened here. So, but their availability is so much reduced because there's a couple of the P's, some of them are knowing them. So if it's a fire in our community, they come here. I don't get that commitment. But if it's fire someplace else, where are they going to go?
Yeah, it work.
So that's the juggling that we always have. So I just wanted to get that.
I think we all appreciate the mastery that you have accompanied using to have the balls up there. I mean,
a little more of that for you because.
Oh, okay, you're not done. So let me just summarize this if I can. So the changes to your operating budget, exclusive of the building, are really only two, the salary and the training.
Yep.
And then the building, you're just suggesting that we keep it level funded from last year.
Yep.
And that seems to make sense. The building is not a new building, you know, it's not a new building.
That allows us to kind of take some of those projects that we've started on this year.
Okay.
And continue along and then pick some of the other issues out of it.
Yeah.
And the reason why the training thing is there, like I said, is because training and getting certification is extremely hard to find for these guys because you've got to travel to Concord or any place in the state because they're just not like right down the street. We had one of our members that went all the way to Moultonboro last year for his level two certification. Moulton Girls and Island Program, so it's the closest class you can find. There's going to be a class in North Berwick that they're putting on that's going to be level one and level two. So it's a pro board certification, and what that means is you get that certification, it's good in 32 states. So if I wanted to go work in Arkansas or Montana, I can take my certification and you're good to go. It's the same curriculum, it's a nationwide thing. Those are hard to come out. So with the three new members that I had stated we're looking to get on and then some of our members that want to finish the level two, that's why I want to just get a little bit more so I can make sure I can get all these guys in, get them certified. We have spots for them. We've already kind of reserved that. I just want to make sure we can do that and that we don't take it all drain right from the beginning because there's always something that comes up during the year. That's why I'm requesting that. Because these classes about $650.
And then they pay
at all? They pay. Once they come in, they get a certificate, they pay half.
It's not a bad deal.
No, it's an enticement.
Yeah.
And we actually have a contract that if we're going to pay you half, you're going to give us at least a year of your time.
Mm-hmm. Where you pay all that.
Where you pay all that.
Makes sense.
We'll try to get something for what we're investing in.
Yeah. All right, any other questions about the budget? Okay.
Not on that one. Just the cares. Carrying it a little bit further, as we had talked about radios for the new engine. And then we had that discussion. Sat down and had the latest numbers from Caroline on where we sit. And this week should be the delivery of the community. was like 32 or whatever, 32, 33. It's like $6,000 left on the warrant for outfitting the vehicle. Yeah, the outfit, radios, lights, striping, and all that is about $8,500. So we'll use the rest of the warrant article and money from this year's existing budget. We've sat down, and I sat down tonight with the other members of the fire department, the other chief officers, and we earmarked about $15,000 left in our budget from areas of training, equipment line, vehicle repair, because we haven't made any huge hits in any of those areas.
What'd you do?
Yeah,
I knocked on wood.
Yeah.
With our activity last week, the forestry sitting over at the maintenance yard getting some repairs because the cable that runs from the transmission from the shift to the transmission froze up and you couldn't move it, so the truck wouldn't know whether to go forward or back. So it's over there. But that's not an expensive item to take care of. But $2,500 to $3,000 out of the existing vehicle. And then we could also find the $5,000 out of existing here, this year's funding, for the radio, for the new engine. So we're looking for $700,000 coming out of that number that I just, the 15 that I just said. So it covers our needs to get our new equipment on the road, up and ready to run, without asking for any more additional funds, stuff that's already here.
We're not skipping on hose replacement.
So talk about that tonight. We're still going to order our hose. I've made our inquiries because we do need to purchase some protective clothing, the stuff that's out of date for some of our members, so we need to replace some of that. That's still going to be there. These are areas that we don't have to skip on. The other thing that I'm going to throw at you is, with that being said, probably going to leave us anywhere $6,000 to $7,000 still left.
Can I stop you right here? I just want to make sure I've heard okay.
Yep.
So you went through and you looked at you projected your expenses for the rest of the year, and with that sort of $15,000, you think you can with that manage the overage in detailing the command vehicle,
yep,
and also the radios from new firing.
New radios.
That's okay. I just wanted to make sure that
yes,
that was all set. And there's still some money.
Yes, there's still some
back at you.
Okay. The truck is the rear is being built. It's about 40% constructed. The frame is already set and ready to go. We've had a couple of conversations with Jerry McKay, the rep, and as always, there was this little wish list that we always had. But since when we designed the truck and spec'd it out, we were like, four.
It's a big number.
We were right there.
Yeah.
There's some wish list items here. And my thought is if some of that is still going to be left, if that could be used for some of these wish items, if that's something that could be accomplished.
Do you wish?
Yes.
We wish for some upgrades to the engine itself. Basically, what it is it's one is a 600 pound rollout compartment. And what that does is the truck is going to be designed so that eventually down the road we can put the extrication tool, the jaws of life, if we want to use that, because everybody understands that. So we can just roll it right out of the truck and it's all ready to go. The reason why we want to carry that on this piece is otherwise it's on another truck. And if we have three guys show up that can get on the engine, well, this is on the other truck. So I need another guy to get that on there. So basically, you put all your toys on that first piece that may have enough people so you can get it. So that's one thing that we would like to have added to it. Not a larger engine. The truck itself, it's for the rescue tool. A compartment shelf that will slide out. And it's a 600 pound weight capacity, so it will hold the tool, the extrication tool.
When you said the word engine, did you mean a truck? Is that where I went wrong?
Yeah. Well,
engine
meaning truck.
Yes, okay.
Engine meaning you stepped on the gas.
Yes, okay. I'm sorry. So we're talking about like a storage.
Yes,
just
a compartment with a rollout tray that's capable of handling this additional equipment.
I'm with you down. I'm sorry. I was like, I couldn't make this thing.
Well, in the fire service vernacular, engine is the truck.
Is the whole truck, yes.
It's engine three, engine two.
Got it.
Not just the little thing that freaks
out.
I understand the confusion. I'm sorry if I led you that way.
So that was one thing we were looking at, and in the compartment, another thing is a tool board. It's a vertical tool board, so that when you open the open compartment door, you can slide it out, and it has a compartment for each one of the needed fittings and whatnot to run the pump. And on the other side, it has stuff so you can mount an axe, and mount a sledgehammer, and mount other tools right there, slide it out, you can pick this up right now. Rather than have it thrown in a compartment, and you're gonna dig your way through to try to find what you want. It's just to make things much more manageable. It's right there, you can pick it right out.
It's a safety issue, every second is valuable.
Yeah, so looking at those two items, you know, one is $1,200, one is $1,300. So those were things that we had originally put into the specs. When we got down to crunch time, it was like, okay, this, we can wait.
Are there time constraints on the decision for these things?
They're building it right now, probably.
So it's not something you can retrofit or not readily retrofit. It's part of it.
Oh, we could.
But.
We could, but it's money from this year's budget that we'd like to expend rather than have it to find it future down the road. Because looking, like I said, looking at everything we had, we're gonna more than meet all our needs. It's still something that's very similar to 4 years ago when we were needing it at the end of the year. So okay, we did extract it. And like I said, we'll get it because we had that extra money sitting within the budget.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, it's safety, it's your budget, these are safety issues, they're having to do with the construction, so they're better to be made when it's in construction.
While it's being done, yes.
And this was something you were gonna do anyway.
Had you been able to?
We would have had to piecemeal it in as time would allow. But right now, like I said, looking over all this and where we are, the way things have gone, our expenditures have not reached, you know, we've had not the issues that we may have anticipated.
So will we need to do a change order?
Mm-hmm. Find out from Jerry McKay, I don't know if it's a change order, if it's just something that's an addition, but I will find out.
So if it's a change order, so what we can do is just, as part of that change order, say that any overage from the warrant will be charged to the operating budget.
Right.
The supplies line, the equipment line, some suitable one.
I just wanted to make sure I touch
base meeting on Saturday
with all of you guys. And you guys can, you know, hash that out until we decide. Because I'll talk to people to just kind of contact them. I'll talk to Jerry.
Yeah, but we're not meeting next Monday, Jose.
Right.
So, but we can do, you said you
we,
noticed the
we
meeting. Noti- so
we notified us that we can conduct any urgent or time constrained business on Saturday.
If you get an answer.
If you have an answer before then and want to give us anything to consider.
Yeah, I can probably.
Otherwise, we won't be meeting again until the 6th.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I still think, and I think I'm still probably fine.
Okay. So just keep in mind.
The truck is until mid to late December. So they'll build a box and then we'll do it in our tray and you have to change some brackets. It's not anything that's going to be extending the delivery of the truck.
You could say engine. I'm in the context now.
Engine two. I think is what it's going to be. Okay.
Was that your list looks longer than just two items, Chief?
It is. It is longer than two items. Those are the two that we prioritize.
Okay.
The things we would like to have now. I mean, if there's enough, then we can go that way. But those two would be a big addition to.
Okay.
Making
so I think the board sounds
efficient.
Amenable. So I think if you were to raise a change order for whatever device is appropriate, whether it's a PO or I don't know, but or both.
Yeah, I'll find out exactly what that procedure
is. But and we'll make sure that the change order, because I think we've maxed out pretty much the warrant article, so the change order will just have to say, just for purposes of accounting and a rod or whatever.
It is maxed out, correct.
Yeah. Anything above the warrant will get charged to.
Other than that, everything else in the budget is
So, even looking at expenditures to this point, there's still some other ones in here, but there's still other funds sitting there that we got to know. So, you know, it's the end of the year and we start so, there's still going to be some other stuff.
Yeah, well, it's good. They sound like good stuff.
Things that will make it that much more user friendly for all of us. Yeah, I mean, that's another thing. I'm going to talk about not having people that come in waving the fire truck under the nose and they don't want people to come in. So,
do you want us to go to non-public to talk about
whatever it is that's on your mind. It's up to you.
Yeah, I mean, why don't we just do that for a couple of minutes? Doesn't have to be any long run out.
Personnel.
Just kind of throw something out there, you know, just kind of expand on what we've kind of had.
Okay, I want that we know in a non-public session to deal with personnel issues.
Do a roll call, Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne?
Yes.
Is the summer working as a trail?
Ooh, it's chilly in here.
I forgot my sweatshirt at home.
I feel like I'm at the ice arena again.
Does he have any man currently or not?
Bob turned it down. Bob did it.
And he didn't change it back when he left? And none of us goofballs don't want to run.
They may want you to come back to ask some questions.
I think Jody does.
Because he knows how to do it temporarily, anyway.
Turn off the cool air.
Thursday.
Cool air was on, so I turned it off.
Yeah, that's what he did, because it was 80 in here. They must have it set on 80. Because the thing, every time we come in for a meeting, it says 80.
Yeah, Kevin hanged at a couple of places, I couldn't, was trying to remember that, couldn't remember. Kevin, Jody, sitting next to me, to my left. Oh, no, nothing, no one, there weren't questions that people didn't want to do, that there were a priority.
Trying to understand what it was and why we needed it.
Or if you need it faster than.
Yeah, it's just, again, it's just a logistical thing to keep on this water. The other thing that's been an issue with that, I can speak for him, in fact, that we would like to train weekly, or just 5 monthly. A lot of times we don't, we'll say, hey, we can't use all our bottles, we don't have any reserve. We call Summersworth and they're unavailable.
This is an aside.
We just cut down our capabilities.
Yeah.
I can't allow that.
This is an aside, not, yeah.
The other thing that I have is Dover now has one of those systems, like.
It's the air filling.
The CIPA question, just ask them to go come back, that's all, so, that's all.
Winter time's here. Is the fire department going to flood the ice rink this year and light it?
We can.
Okay.
You know, I know, does he still have a rec committee that's doing all that stuff and all that? Yeah, we can, we still have all the stuff, but one of them, you know, whatever it needs to support that.
Yeah, we have people that will build it out, but obviously you're the water supply, so.
All they gotta do is, you know, if they have it all ready to go and the weather starts to cooperate, we can definitely do the stuff.
Do you feel that as needed or we tell you when? I don't know how it worked last year.
It was both.
Okay.
Because Sean kind of took care of that, so, you know, of course he has access, he could go down and, you know, if the weather was just right, let's go down and flood it, get it to.
Okay.
Get it to go if the weather wasn't gonna be, but either way, I mean, they can contact it, we can run a line out there.
Okay.
Do what we gotta do, the light's there, we just set the timer, they can do what they gotta do.
Okay, awesome. Thanks.
All right, so back to department head business, we still have a couple of departments to deal with. So one is under the building inspector with the minimum housing standards. I sent out.
Did you put all the highway down? The roof is still there.
We didn't even touch them, he just gave.
No, are you here, last year you stayed for the whole meeting, so I don't.
Oh, okay.
I'm just trying to see how things go.
Oh, I didn't know if you were waiting, I didn't want you to wait if you, you're more than welcome to stay.
But you're right, Michael, we dealt with the purchase orders and then.
If we didn't do all of this, I'd be waiting for that, I don't want to go home.
No, that was a good check, good check. So, but considering that you're gonna stay for a little bit, we'll do the building inspection and then we'll get to the highway transfer station. So I sent out or gave you links to the current minimum housing standards with the last revisions. So are we ready?
I believe so.
Okay, so I will ask Caroline to post the public hearing on November 6th at 6:00. And we'll get that in order and hopefully we'll have housing standards before too long, that would be really helpful.
Did we book that last week? We booked that last week.
We didn't, we said we, no, because we were waiting, we were still waiting for some last minute edits from Tom, I believe. And we wanted to make sure Michael had a chance to weigh in.
We're going to review the one set.
Yes, so we did.
My calendar right now.
I'm sorry.
I don't have my phone, so I'm making myself.
Okay. So we'll have a public hearing at 11, on November 6th at 6:00 and we'll post it and we'll take it from there. Are we willing to talk about septic fees? The... I don't know that we had actually agreed. Tom came to see us. He told us why he thought we needed him to review them, A, and B, to introduce the fee that would be part of the, you know, building permit.
If we agree that the town building inspector should review them, we should charge a fee to cover that cost.
And he was suggesting $50.
I don't know if that's the number or not, but what are the other, I believe you that's what he said, I don't know.
That's what he said.
I don't know what the other, so 90 for electrical, right? And plumbing. And there are other...
He has to actually inspect those.
Right.
So
I'm just looking at where it falls in line, that's all. It was in between. It's expensive part of putting the septic system.
So we have had them go through, he has looked at them.
He looks at them.
Right.
And he has talked to some people, I think.
But then revisions were made because the state didn't allow whatever. So is it worth it? Because right now it's just a stamp. And it's really the state's discretion anyway. So, because whatever he said was fine, the state said no, and then they had to redo it anyway.
Mine.
Yours too? Okay, two. Two that I know of. So,
if the board doesn't want to introduce the fees,
I'm just trying to remember the cover. It's been a few weeks, so the last...
$20 or whatever.
When he talked, yeah, I guess it was like 25. I would cut it now. I wouldn't do 50, but if we're going to do anything. But we were under the impression that it was just really a rubber stamp. Oh, the town's got it. Here's our coffee. And go along your merry way, but that's how it was explained to us, right?
It is how it was explained to us.
But then Tom said, well, not necessarily. It says here that we have reviewed it, and then we're signing off on it. Now, it's very true that the state may say, well, no, you still have to do something different, but... We're actually saying we have reviewed those plans. I'm not going to lie, I have no training or expertise in judging whether or not the septic system is adequate or not. So I would think we would probably want the building inspector to do it. But I don't think $50 is the right number, though.
I'll make a motion for $25.
Sure, I'll second that.
You second that?
Yep.
All right, so there's a motion and a second to institute a $25 fee to have the town review septic plans that are then forwarded to the city.
Suzanne, what do you think? I mean, I think it's really just a... before, when it was explained to me, it would be ludicrous for me to say I want any money for what we were... because we were just stamping them, we'd send them on their way. But if we're really supposed to be...
Well, now we have a building inspector for whom we have an hourly rate who's looking at them.
Yeah.
So this, you know, this helps fund that.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm fine with the 20... We have a motion and a second
sure,
for 25. So I'm okay with that.
All right.
I'll call the question. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So we'll change the building permit accordingly. Okay, now we're at the transfer station. So there is no updates on the transfer station.
Employee.
Part-time Saturday person.
Right. Transfer station, before we get to transfer station fees.
What did you do last week when I wasn't
here? Oh, we did something we shouldn't have done, actually.
Yes.
But we're going to undo it and
okay.
See if we want to redo it. But before we get to that, what's not here on the agenda, I see, is the full-time assistant. Or not the transfer station, but the highway department.
Okay.
So the search committee for our new road agent that recommended George to us, as a committee suggested that we seriously consider hiring a full-time assistant.
Right.
And we heard from some of those members individually. We heard from Nate individually. I spoke with Michael Poynton individually. So there was some very strong sentiment that said we should do that. So I may have said to the board that I'm working those numbers into the next year's budget. When George came on board, he asked us last week to seriously consider hiring someone now. We're having a hell of a time trying to get a plow driver. And so if we move it forward, or whatever the direction is, and hire someone now with a CDL, that person can be the second licensed plow driver.
Okay.
And we would have Mike Dion, and hopefully we would have another larger pool, but you know, at least we would have some a core.
Right.
So I, you know, after I fanned myself, I took a look at the numbers.
I'm finding this.
Yes, okay, so if you give me a minute, I'm going to bring up a spreadsheet. So to cover somebody for the rest of the year, assuming that we can bring somebody on board, I think I started it the first week in November 6th, which is probably unlikely, but let's just, that gives us 8 weeks, right? So it just, this would be the max amount. At $17 an hour, which is, I believe, the amount that we are currently, has currently been mentioned to us, we can put an ad that says between 15 and 17, whatever, depending on experience. So that hourly rate, 40 hours a week for the remainder of the year, times the payroll, and plus the payroll taxes, the retirement system, health insurance, and I did it for a max, like a family membership, would cost us about $8,100. And so that's the amount of money that we have to scour the budgets for.
Okay.
So there is $2,000, so we came up with a pool of about $12,000. Okay, so it still gives us some room in case one of these doesn't work out exactly.
And hopefully nothing else goes wrong by the end of the year.
Right.
All right.
So professional services, I believe, can contribute $2,000 to this.
Okay.
Planning consultant, and I was looking to you, and I may have sent this in an email. Unless there's some extraordinary need for John Krebs from now to the end of the year, his pace of remuneration would allow us to take $2,000 from that. Let me just tell you where it currently is.
Thank you. I don't know.
Yep. Hang on just a minute.
It may be possible, but there are a number of ongoing issues, and it may be contributing more time to it. I don't know. I sent in an email.
So he has, let's see, hang on just a minute. He recently submitted an invoice that we paid, and so
how much was it?
$400, I think.
Okay. So we have,
I'll make different 500 just
two more meetings by the end of the year. So how much is left in his line?
It doesn't seem right. Hang on just a second. Pardon? Yeah, there was the couple of, yeah, so I think I did my math wrong here. So there would be 3,400 left in the line.
Even if you took two away?
No.
Oh.
So 1,400 if you take two away.
Let me ask him. I'll call him tomorrow and ask him what he anticipates.
If 1,400 would cover his services for the remainder of the year. So we looked at transfer station attendance, and we can pull 2,000 from there. We looked at the highway department repair and maintenance, and we can take 1,500 from there based on what George suggested. And then there's 4,500 from the roadside mowing, which we're just not going to be able to do this year because of timing and,
yeah,
you know, our contractor just couldn't produce the equipment.
Right.
So all of those total to 12,000. So there's a little, almost 4,000 of.
Okay, so there was I don't want to call cushion.
Yeah, I don't want to call fluff either,
right,
but in case one of these, let's say the planning consultant came.
Right, because we've got two ongoing cases, the Shady Lane and, which I thought was going to be resolved this month, but apparently not, and Ink Street, Lewin, Mr. Aspie, imaginary Mr. Aspie across the street. There will be more technical review for that in November. And I don't know about, I'll ask them about December. So, I mean, I don't know what that, how many hours that represents for those two cases. So, and anything else that comes up, I mean, you don't know. Someone comes in with a, I don't know. Subdivision somewhere, I don't know. A magical one somewhere. And we have to deal with it, I mean.
All
right. But I'll call him tomorrow.
Well, but we probably, based on conversations with Jordan, need to act on this sooner rather than later. Because
well, you said there's approximately 4,000 you could have
yes,
to move around.
Yes.
That's, I think that's.
Does that give you comfort level?
I think so, yeah.
Yes.
All right. Worst case scenario, he wouldn't be bumping that. He hasn't used his full line in the last year or so, has he? He didn't last year, did he?
Correct.
But we do have more. More going on, I guess, but not much more. All right, so I'm more comfortable with it, but I'll ask him
a lot. I mean, it would be good to get to know anyway, just in case something else comes down the pipe that we have to scramble for. So, all right, so given that, does the board feel comfortable then in giving the okay to hiring a full-time assistant for the highway department at between $15 and $17 an hour?
Yes.
So here's a motion from Jody.
Sure, I'll second. We'll
okay, so I have a motion and a second. So so I've already built this into next year's budget, obviously. I didn't
that
think we were
going
to backfill
question.
It, but it's
right.
It's there. I mean, we'll see it Saturday. We are meeting Saturday at 9.
Do we?
Right?
No, yeah.
Yeah.
Did we not have that in the last time we met? We hadn't plugged that in yet?
Mm-hmm.
Probably April. I think it was, but I think it started April.
Okay, all right.
So I had to put it back to January.
And we're confident we can find someone in the next several
weeks?
Well,
let's ask
George.
I have somebody in mind. I know it's going to go through the process, and I'm willing, you know.
Right, but you have some people that you know you can call on to ask.
Yeah.
And I know of other towns where people know that they won't be able to climb the ladder where they are. Would be willing to work for a full-time position.
Okay.
Because they don't want to, it's the part-time that makes it hard.
Right.
Because they have to find full-time work, and then just as everything else happens, it's easier to.
So will this person be eligible for overtime?
Yes.
Or
so I
you
built.
Consider that for plowing, I mean.
I built some overtime into the FY 18 budget. There is no overtime built into this, so we'll have to.
But we have a winter help line still, right?
We
so
do.
You didn't rob that.
We did
okay.
We did not rob
right.
those.
Right.
We reviewed them today with George,
right.
And
so
we didn't rob them.
Available.
And we did say, well, we may not need as much of the temporary help inside, you know, the
right
that we currently have with.
It's long overdue. We need.
We used to have a full time.
Yeah, and we need it again.
Before our time.
Before our time, yeah. And we need to go back to those days for sure. I mean, it's
so we can act on the motion and then talk about the process of that.
Sure.
All right, so I will call a question. Is the board willing to hire a full-time assistant for between $15 and $17 per hour?
Yes.
Yeah.
All those in favor say aye. Sorry, I didn't quite finish that, did I?
No.
All right, so that, and I will say aye, and that passes.
All right.
So now the question is, how do we get this out there? Who does, who's going to interview, et cetera, et cetera?
We should post the same way we always have.
Do we have a job description? Do we need a job description?
I've been stating from other towns. George, you probably already have something.
No, I don't have nothing.
Okay, so, like I've been pulling from the Municipal Association and.
It could be all about the same.
Right, so.
So you could just have something that says in support of and just list the same things that.
Yeah, it would be listed as a highway department laborer, full-time laborer, correct?
Truck driver laborer, we'll put that in.
Yeah, probably truck driver because the CDL is the important piece. So that would be one of the primary requirements, I think, is the CDL.
Yeah, that should be a requirement.
Yeah, the person that you have in mind has a CDL?
Class A.
Class A, even better.
So one of, so.
Mechanic experience too, I mean.
Yeah, so we could, once we advertise it, advertise it in a reasonably short period. I mean, reasonable, but not long. And call it a rolling, you can call it, we do something like we did with George. We will look at all applications that arrive at this point.
Yep.
But we're not obligated to look at any beyond it as soon as we find somebody from that point on.
And I would think it would be George and the three of us.
That would be more than sufficient. I would say.
Well, me and George want to meet. I'm still free until the 7th of November.
Okay.
We could have them.
And then come and meet with us. That's fine.
Yes, does that work? So like a pre-processing system, so the two of them.
That's fine.
And then you can do it during the day.
So I'll get with you to see what you want to post tomorrow. And then I'll get with Caroline to post. What end date do you want to give it?
It's going to depend on when you're going to be ready to get the.
Tomorrow.
For posting on Wednesday, so I would say maybe a week Friday, Friday.
Yes.
So Thursday?
That's a good day.
All right.
Third?
Is it your birthday? So.
So November 3rd?
Yeah.
So that gives it.
Yeah, just in case, I mean, you know.
You can get under 2 weeks.
Pardon?
You can get under 2 weeks.
Not quite 2 weeks, no, it'll be about a week and a half.
Yeah.
Okay. That's 10 days.
I'll email Caroline, tell her.
And you can start to interview people before, just what we're going to say is that if it comes in before the, whatever, the 3rd, we will review, the committee will review it. Doesn't mean that anybody can be called in, but you'll look at it and look at it. Whereas if it comes in afterwards, we don't even have to look at it. But if we haven't found anybody, then you can continue to roll through, you know, just modified rolling or.
Yeah.
Candidacy period. All right, so let's hope. Let's hope we can get our roads plowed.
Yeah, that would be nice, I would think.
Yes. All right. Let me get back to the agenda. So that was not on it. So I added it to mine. Full-time highway department assistant. All right, the other thing is transfer station fees. So Jody and I voted on this last week. We voted to increase the fee to $20. No second fee, it's still $20. Third sticker, still $20. Whatever the price, our auditor did tell us he recommended to us that we just have one price per sticker.
Okay.
That it is difficult for him to audit. They're not, the control mechanism isn't there for them to be able to tie in a half price for a second vehicle. So he said, whatever you do, it really is better to have just one hand fee price. So I'm just, that's his recommendation. We are still the governing body, we can do what we want. So I was only half right about the fact that we don't need a public hearing. It is true we don't need a public hearing. It is true that the board can. can vote on the transfer station fees, the sticker fees, and all of the other fees. However. Pardon?
We had a public hearing the last time.
That's possibly. But what we do need to do is we need to post our proposed increase and with the date on which we're going to vote on it. So, well, it's not a public hearing, they can come, and if it's community input, they can, you know, it's sort of like a, if somebody wants to say something.
So we're not gonna have a hearing like last time?
If it is, if you would like to have a hearing. We are, we voted on the 13th.
That's November 13th.
Yes.
You could have it, tonight, George.
Eric, George.
You could have it, you could have it that night, still vote that night.
Yeah.
I mean, there was such consternation when we raised it to $10, that, I didn't think it would be the right thing to do to have a public hearing.
Joni?
Only one member.
Sure.
All right, so if we, 6 o'clock on the 13th? All right.
So did you all look at, how much this, increase will raise?
Just 1 minute, what is the cost of money? Well, we doubled it, right?
Right.
No, that's not what you hope, or you may think, but then, some people won't buy two.
Correct, but people who do will.
So I was thinking it might make sense, if we were considering to raise the fee, to do it just $10 across the board for the first and the second vehicle, I think $20. I understand that probably still doesn't even make our, cover our costs, but.
It's like $1.60 a month.
We went from a dollar a year, wasn't it, to $10, but we didn't change it in 20 years. I'd say we, the town. Then to 10, it's just, people may see it as a.
So you wanna keep it at 10 for all vehicles and no $5 second vehicle?
Yeah, well, I'm just saying, I'm just saying, if we were gonna do it, maybe that might make sense.
So how much do you think?
I'm sorry, I'm just still putting it in the calendar, sorry, I just.
So at $20 per sticker, it's $1.67 a month. At $10, it would be half that, right, 80 something a month, 82, 84, whatever, 82 cents.
Still a lot cheaper than bag and tag.
So while it is a doubling, one could argue that it is still not unreasonable, and it serves to make the users of the transfer station somewhat more responsible for the cost associated with the transfer station. Not entirely, it's still being subsidized by the entire town, So that was the rationale. The front office also said, please don't make it 15, because then they have to make, you know,
they run out of fives.
Run out of fives.
Yeah, I think we could probably have, make sure they have enough fives on hand, but, I don't know, that's a steep cliff to get over.
That is not insurmountable.
Not at all, but, if we need to increase the fee, if we feel like we need to, to offset the operating costs, which I understand we may need to, I would be much more comfortable just having 10 equipped 10 for the first and the second vehicle. But if you both want to do 20, I.
Well, I'll just remind you that the $10 per month, or the $10 per year per vehicle is 82 cents to dispose of your garbage.
Plus whatever you pay in your, for taxes.
Correct, but everybody's paying. So what I as a user am not paying by paying
$20. I have a dumpster for our condos. I mean, I get it. I mean, but
yes.
I don't have a transfer station sticker on my car. I want Kate's, but when they want mine, but
yeah.
I don't think that ever.
I mean, the question is $20 unreasonable to dispose of municipal solid waste and the ability to recycle?
Again, it's a lot cheaper than bag and tag.
So obviously, Jody and I are on record as agreeing with, you know.
Yeah, I mean, if that's what you want to do, it's fine. I'm not gonna, I don't wanna hold up the rest of the meeting just on that, so if you're both comfortable with that, it's, we should go to public hearing, it's okay.
All right, so did we actually have a motion? We should start all over again with the motion.
You did.
I don't know what we're doing. Do we have one right now?
I'm gonna wait for it.
We don't have a motion.
We don't have one right now, okay, so. Yes.
We don't.
Okay, so I will entertain a motion to raise the transfer station fee to $20 per vehicle, all vehicle, each vehicle, $20. Second? I will second that. Any further discussion on that issue? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed say no.
No.
All right, the ayes have it. Thank you.
No, but if it was always unanimous, it'd be very boring, so.
Once a year, we have to throw one out there.
I'm not falling on my sword either way, so I mean.
All right, so we will get the.
But do you think a public hearing is very?
Yeah, they have to post it now.
Either way, I mean, regardless of how.
So now it'll be on the 13th at 6.
All right, any other information that we wanna say about the transition, transfer station, I mean, the highway department transition, I mean, George has been here.
The transition itself has been going quite well. He is going to be fixing the back of the building that was hit last winter. Probably next week, it was never fixed. George noticed his first day, and he also noticed his first day that the cars were never inspected in September. So,
Vehicles.
Yes.
I hear you.
So, he instead of calling Townsend back out to fix the gauge on the oil tank, he fixed it himself. And, Mike, you weren't here, the police department, since they got their new computers with their grant, one of their pro services, Lieutenant John, wiped it clean of their use, brought it over to them. He has a new printer and, computer and.
Perfect.
And a mouse.
Great.
So he's all set down there with the wireless capability, so he's doing savvy, ready to go today.
Good, perfect.
Down to be this afternoon.
Excellent, that's good, thank you, RPD, we should really have Chief Ducharme, only we've remembered. Okay, anything else that you might wanna add?
The transition? No, nothing to think of.
All right, thank you. Kellwin Drive, so I heard from, Mr. Bobinski, I'm fumbling for his first name, who is. Mike, yes, who's head of DPW or something.
Summersworth.
Yep, in Summersworth. Because I had talked to him once about, you know, if you're gonna do something around the Kellwin Drive area, let us know.
Right.
So they're not doing Kellwin Drive, but they are doing some stuff, and he said to, you know, check in with Pike. So I dashed off an email to Chris, it would cost $12,000, was what Mike Bobinski said. So I dashed off an email to Chris saying, well, we're interested, but what are you doing, and is it really 12, is it less? And I haven't heard back, so I'll try to touch base again. So that's.
I think we just use that 12, didn't we hire her again?
Well, there's the New Hampshire DOT money that.
Oh, yeah.
Potentially.
Of course, yes, I forgot about that.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
Okay. I mean, I'm not saying that we would do it, I'm still trying to find out whether he could, and how much it would cost us.
Speaking of Pike, I can wait till we get that. Is CIP on here somewhere?
No, probably not.
Okay, that's fine. We'll talk about it now quickly if you don't mind.
Yes, sure.
We want to get prices, the fire department, in front of the fire department, and their side paving, their sidewalk, they want to get that paved. But in front of the building where the trucks sit and they come in and out, it's sinking in front of the, no, it's on my eyes, sorry. In front of the new addition.
Yes, I think they told us that we are aware of.
Apparently we weren't involved in the process, so I'm just taking Mark's word for it, that when it was put in, the right amount of fill wasn't actually put in. I know it's hard to believe that we might not have done things all the way, to save a buck, but I get it. So it's sinking even more. So the question was, would Pike be able to give us an estimate on how much it might cost to fill that in, to engineer it properly, and pave the side parking lot?
Can we ask George first? I wonder,
sure.
George, just for,
sure.
If we're just looking for a ballpark budgeting figure,
sure.
Yeah.
With that?
Sure. If he's,
could you touch base with him? The only thing that we need to make sure you understand is that we need some kind of stabilization or compression or something in the front, not the side, but the front.
Just the front, right.
Because it, the heavy equipment is causing it to.
And the question is, does it make sense to do all of the front? It doesn't seem to be causing a problem now, but you know, you do half of it, and then all of a sudden.
Is it, you mean it's just the new bay?
Yeah, it might make sense to do the entire front portion, so we want to get.
Yeah, it may not need the full compaction, but.
Right.
Again, it's
sort of
like a, well, we're just, you know, ballparky. I wouldn't know what to tell you, right? And you wouldn't probably know what to tell us.
No.
So, and if he doesn't feel comfortable, we'll see.
If you were actually meeting with.
Chris?
With Chris, it just, you know.
If it works out, I absolutely will. Right now, he's not responding.
He's never seen going back, well, we've gone to the votes, we've done.
Exactly, I don't want to, yeah, exactly. So you'll have to, that's why I'm trying.
That's fair enough.
I'm hoping that George.
I hope George can do it. I've been trusting, but I'm having one in the position for a couple of weeks, so.
Easy to forget. Okay, the other thing that came up on is George related to me that November 11th is Saturday.
Yeah.
And so the observed holiday, I guess, is Friday.
Yeah.
However, so what the attendants are proposing is that they stay open on Saturday, which is our busiest day.
Yeah.
But that they close on Monday, in which case we would give them holiday pay.
Right.
On that day. So that's you know, it would just be a one time because of the calendar this year.
Right.
So that was the request.
We did this for other holidays, right?
I think there was another holiday where something like that happened.
Christmas, what, Memorial Day, maybe?
It is quite possible.
No, but Memorial Day was a Monday, so it had to be, yeah.
I don't know, but anyway, this year, the observed holiday is Friday, and we're not open. The actual day, though, is the 11th, and they're suggesting that we keep it open.
Right.
And but are requesting that we close it the following Monday, and then we would give them.
We start putting those signs up now.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I agree. But that, can we? Are we going
to
decide that that's what we want to do, Joni?
Yes, that is really nice of them, actually.
I mean, that's the model we followed before, right? So yeah.
It is the model we followed. Okay, I don't think we need a motion on that. I will just say by consensus, and
it's great that we're
I'll let George know, and we'll ask Caroline to get PR out.
Yeah.
And George can start to do PR.
So we need signs here at the island, Facebook, town website.
Are you going to manage that?
If you put it to make something up, then yes, we can push it out. But the signs, yeah, we'll have to work on that.
I guess what I'm saying is
the transfer station is not going to be enough.
Mm-hmm.
So this, if we want to do the sandwich boards, I mean, we have asked Salmoni to do them. So my only point is we need, it's not just rattling off, this has to be done, this has to be done. Who's going to do it, each of those things? That's kind of where I'm going.
Mm-hmm.
So let me, and I'm going to make my note here. So TS, transfer station, open 11-11, closed on 11-13, staff gets holiday pay. All right, so now the notices. How are we going to do that? I could certainly let Caroline know so she can do the posting, post office, town hall, and web.
Mm-hmm. And then from the web, we can take it from the town hall and push it out to the other rooms for happenings, pages, or whatever, and our own. And then it's the sandwich boards on the outskirts of town that need it for the people that are not media savvy.
Would you like to ask Salma, would you like us to ask Salma if she can do that?
If you...
I can't do those boards on my own.
Well, we'll
Who
move
does them?
Them. We'll move them for you if you create the...
Okay.
That's all we meant, is to getting the insert.
Okay.
Not the putting them out, just the...
And when are you going to put these out?
As soon as we can, I think.
I'm not available at all this week.
Okay.
Not until after the tax bills are stopped.
We don't have tax bills yet.
I know, but I don't have an e-sky written yet either.
I guess. That's true. Have you heard from the select board yet?
No, I haven't.
You heard from me.
Slackers. Slackers.
I have something drafted, but this, I'm not, A, I'm not done, and B, this board needs to review it. So, all right, so is there?
So I really.
Understood, it's okay.
Do we have poster board here already?
No, I have some at home.
Okay. Do you mind bringing it in and I'll just make them up?
Sure.
Okay.
You have to cut it. Well, why don't we look though in there and see how many, what I did was I flipped the back of the town meeting signs up blank.
Okay.
And if there's enough there, they might be.
Okay.
And there's some big markers in there.
I could buy poster board for $50.
After I sit with George tomorrow, I'll look at that.
All right, so you'll take care of sandwich boards. Okay, so I think we're all set. All right, I think we're done with the department stuff. So regular town administration. Project updates. We had the final inspection on the culverts, as I said earlier tonight. We are awaiting the final pay rec. I think we did get the pay rec for Parker Brothers and Hoyle Tanner is reviewing it. It has come in somewhat lower, not a whole lot, don't get excited. And, but we don't have, unless I heard later this afternoon, we've not heard from Hoyle Tanner. Correct, we've not heard from them. With regard to the construction oversight, so. USDA was not there for the inspection, but our program officer, Ann Getchell, is gonna come down November 1st to walk the culverts. I said that I would be happy to show them to her. And we're working on the closing documents. So both our bond council has some deliverables that we need to get to them, as well as USDA. So we're looking at a closing either around the, somewhere in November, the 6th, the 13th, or the 20th. So we'll be having a signing party.
Okay.
For all of those things. And then, you know, pretty soon we can remove this standing agenda item, which would be lovely. Budgets.
Thank you for managing it. You've done a wonderful job.
You're welcome. The culverts do look nice. Parker did a nice job. There were some unanticipated issues, particularly around the lower mill and some around Pine Street, but you know, we've managed to do them and they do look nice. And so that's a very satisfying piece. So budgets, we're gonna meet on Saturday, 9 o'clock, to do FY18 the budget. We've already talked a little bit about some of the this year's budget, both with Chief Rutherford and George, road agent, given that. Tax rate, we've heard nothing. Caroline keeps calling or emailing, we haven't heard. Yep.
Wow.
Well, the MS-1, which is our report on the property valuation,
right.
It gets filed with in a new portal, the equalization portal.
Right.
And somebody there reviews it and then pushes it into the tax portal. So when last we looked, it hadn't been pushed yet.
It shows up as having been received.
They have it.
Yeah.
It's not in the tax portal, it's having been received because it's not there.
Right, no, I understand that, but.
Yeah, so we think that's the only thing. And then of course there's the queue, but
right.
Caroline just doesn't have it. We haven't been able to connect with Michelle Clark. Copier contract. I think there's something in the. Okay, Seco's business machines. All right, we're gonna. Maybe go through the rest and then we'll come back to the copier. Garden Club. So the Garden Club has a tree initiative, and they are donating a tulip tree and would like to plant it.
I saw the email.
Yes.
And I went over to Worcester to get something and didn't go back the same way. So I never went over and looked at it, I apologize.
Well,
I saw that you both looked at it.
Yeah, so Robin is gonna call me tomorrow to find out what we did. So if, so I'm gonna try to explain it to you. So here's the fire station.
Yep.
Here's the side gravelly driveway.
Sure.
Parking lot.
Yep.
Here's the little monument.
Yep.
And over here somewhere is the tree.
Okay.
So it's beyond, and Robin said, you know, we didn't want it to be close to the spruce tree that's associated with the rock and the monument.
Sure, sure, sure.
So it is well beyond that, and she did do some soil sampling.
Yep.
And that is the best spot for the soil.
Okay.
In that general area.
And it's ours right there?
According to Caroline.
Okay.
We mow it.
Wow.
And we mow it. Do you know that whole strip there? Okay.
Yeah. I know that the railroad has a right of way there.
Somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah, when they come back for it, I think we'll talk to them about it. They don't really seem to find anything near their tracks.
So,
okay, sure, why not?
Are we good with, all right, so I will tell the garden club, and Robin Aikman in particular, that to go ahead with the planting of the tulip tree in that spot. Thank you for that. And in the newsletter, the garden club is listing where all of the trees are going, and maybe you can, I gave you that one, didn't I, Salome?
You did, I haven't read it.
Yeah, so I think it's for the tulip tree, it says proposed, so maybe we can just, now that the,
I'll fix it.
Do you want the newsletter to put down how many trees we have to cut down because they're dead?
No, we're not gonna, no. We're just gonna, it's just gonna be good news.
Oh, it's a good news newsletter.
All right. I'm not ready to discuss administrative support.
Okay.
Table.
All right. Old Mill Lane Bridge, I
table.
Did talk to Aaron. It is going to be table, but I can add this. Aaron said, here's what, there's a letter that you can just send to the DOT that says that you're going to put it on your CIP, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
He's going to send us the template for that letter.
Perfect.
So I'll remind him to do that.
So you can let me know what we're going to put on the CIP.
It is, there. I think I put it
there. How much money do we need to put in?
Yeah, the money's there because they've already costed it out. Just we need to let them know, yes, we're gonna go along.
I don't remember, but sure.
Yeah, well, it's in the out year still. There's nothing, I don't think, in the year term.
I just don't remember it, but
it's up on the top, I think. Historical Committee, I sent off an email to Michelle Clark at DRA weeks ago now and have not heard back, so.
Mm. We're meeting on Thursday night.
Wednesday. So I don't have anything to add, I'm afraid.
All right. Not tomorrow.
So we'll try again.
Okay.
Joint loss, anything, job descriptions, anything that you might want to?
They haven't met again, so I don't know if the people that we were waiting for the job descriptions turned in yet.
Okay. Welfare, you know, we're not going to be able to make any progress, I don't think, until we can get, like, the housing ordinance and some of these other things off our list. But I don't want to take it off just yet. All right, so let's come back. I think we're done with everything in the standing items except the copier contract. So, yes, so we did agree to it, at least conceptually, Jody and I, but the contract is here. Now, I didn't have a chance to look at the contract. I know that we received it.
Yes. So.
Can you give us an executive summary?
I can.
Beautiful.
So it's going to be $112 a month for 48 months. It's a locked-in price, plus a $250 a year service contract, I guess you would call it. Includes parts, labor, toner, drums, everything except for the paper. They allow 30,000 black and white copies per year. Any overages is a 0.0059 per page. Color copies are at 5.9 cents per copy page.
And there's no.
Billed quarterly.
Right, so there's no allowance for color. You're paying per color sheet.
Right, and the computer can separate out, if you're doing 5 pages and 2 of them are color, it can separate that out. It's frozen for the 4 years. They did waive the IT person coming in to set it up. And Mike, you'll like this, we can put our phones to it. While we're sitting here in a meeting, we can run something off on our phone.
So remind me of the monthly cost again?
$112 a month.
And it's the plus the $250?
Yep, and then $250 once a year.
Okay, so. And I, so it's about $1,600 a year. So, we have, so we've had, you know, two lines, one called office equipment, one called office equipment repair. So, if you think of them as one,
right.
It's 2,000.
Okay.
And so this would fall well within that. And we would still need to repair, I don't know, telephone is one thing Caroline says, fax, although the fax is usually such that when it goes, it's easier to just buy it.
I would say, does the new copier have fax and scan capability?
Mm-hmm.
Most of the new ones do,
mm-hmm.
So.
So if
I
mean,
really
the
fax
finally goes.
Machine, I would think, but.
I would say I would agree with that once it goes.
Yeah, that sounds good to me. And so all the computers on this floor will finally be networked to go to the printer?
They're not internet work, but it is a networked printer, and so you just set up your print queue to...
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
That's wonderful.
That's the answer to that question.
That's wonderful.
What else? There's something else to consider is what
we're blazing a path to the 20th century.
Yeah. Baby steps, almost.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened, what do we do with this current printer? They will remove it?
They will remove it if we would like, and it gets recycled. For all the parts, it ships off to wherever it gets shipped off to, I think it's in Florida. But we own it, so we have offered it to the fire department. I forgot to ask the chief tonight if he wanted it. He said he would get back to me today, and we both skipped our minds while he was here. So I just emailed him, and he hasn't emailed me back.
Can we sell it to someone? Or give it? I mean, if someone else wants it, I mean, so just recycle. Well, if we recycle, we're not going to get any money for it, right?
They take it away, yeah.
They just
that's
take it away,
their,
so.
Yeah.
Is that part of the deal, though, part of the contract that they have to take it away?
No, we can keep it if we want. Yeah.
So there's also the library, it's another possibility.
Yeah, but they don't have one down there.
They can make money on it.
Okay, that's
fine. So,
yeah, people make copies down there. Yeah, do they just have like a small thing now?
I think it's a desktop multifunction.
Yeah, that would be better than
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
I
mean, so and they still, you know,
until it lasts, and then when it doesn't last, then we.
Chief lost out. That was the library.
So I think we could find a place for it.
Okay. Yeah, we're gonna say instead of just getting rid of it. I mean, if we could use it somewhere.
Right.
I mean, the light might not last long for the library if they use it a lot down there, but the fire might.
Well, you know,
it doesn't make
you
it
know when stress
will
warm up.
Best
so.
Coffee, yeah.
You'll let
so.
Them know.
I don't know.
It'll be fine.
We definitely
so,
need a new one here, so I guess.
So, who wants to reach out to the library? I can do that.
All right, so. So the board did accept or did agree to do this, but this is the actual contract.
Okay.
So, which requires all of our signatures or just one?
Yeah,
Yes, okay, so I would like a motion then to be.
Do I need to have a motion?
I don't know, we didn't talk about the contract, though, I don't know what it was it just a conceptual?
I'll move that we accept the contract with, who is it? Seacoast Business?
Seacoast Business Machine.
For?
A.
Copying service for annual cost.
A one sharp, a sharp, multi-function printer.
Sure.
$412 per month.
With a $230 yearly maintenance.
Yes, yes.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 Aye. I am now going to sign it. I'm gonna put his the email address, Carolyn's, that room at. Accepted by LEC, then is this other personal guarantee? Or is that theirs? It's theirs. Okay. So this outlines the annual maintenance and the thresholds per cost, per page cost. Thank you. That's right.
It was just right. Drop the power one night and just start signing all these papers and that.
This is the setup, okay. And there's the fee. All right, very good. All right. There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Appeal with it?
Pardon?
Was there appeal that I just saw that?
Oh, yeah, we signed it last week.
Okay, we already have.
We signed appeal.
Okay, no, perfect.
It's the contract. All right, so now it is our activities, so we've got standing items, so what we're up to, building permits and correspondence.
Start a full committee's meeting on Wednesday.
Good.
Rec is meeting sometime, November 5th. We're working on the budget now, we're trying to put a team program together, actually.
A what program?
A team program, it will be revenue neutral, it'll be for like, I haven't figured out the exact ages yet, but like 12 to 15, and they'll go on more trips, they'll be hiking and kayaking.
Oh, how fun.
And it will be, like, I'm thinking 4 days a week, and then like maybe a Wednesday is a break day, because they'll sleep all day at home. And they'll like go to the state parks, and we could give them a Water Country pass. If you buy a season pass for Water Country, it's like $60. So if we went every week to Water Country, these are my brain
yeah,
ideas.
Yeah, I understand.
So I'm thinking of that, and then when they're not with us, they'll have a season pass for Water Country. So
now, that's a great idea. The whole budget? The whole budget?
Yes. The whole budget.
When might we see that?
Can I give it to you on the 6th?
You can email it as soon as you have it.
Okay. At that? 9:30.
You can do, yes.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. She did email me what she has. The rec committee hasn't approved it yet.
Yeah, no, that's fine. But what's really important, so we're gonna put the same amount on both sides.
Yes.
And this year, I have to say, for a first-year program, the rec committee came pretty close.
Yeah.
Pretty close. I commend the rec committee. Nice job.
Yep.
Nice job. All right. So I don't think I said last week, because I think it was not on my calendar, but the Seacoast Stormwater Coalition met on Wednesday. And there was a time when Jeff joined me at that, and then he stopped. And so I've asked George to participate, and so he was there, and it was a perfect meeting for him to go to, because we went on a field trip. We went to visit Bill Belanger. If you don't know Bill Belanger, he's amazing. I don't know exactly what his position is, but he manages
The Director of Public Works.
Director of Public Works, okay, so the whole shebang. I wasn't sure what his...
Yeah, Joel is above him, and that's it.
Mm-hmm. So, well, no, there's the other guy. What happened to the other guy?
I don't know.
Yeah, but anyway, it's not important.
I don't know.
But he's been there a long time. He's one of these folks who is really practical, very practical. And the coalition, or the collaboration between Dover Public Works, that is Bill Belanger, and the UNH Stormwater Center,
yep,
and the New Hampshire Department of Environmental Services, have come together, and the ideas of one and Bill's practical ideas and saying, look, we've got to be able to maintain it, have come out with some really interesting ways to manage runoff in roads and this sort of thing. So it's a great contact for us, a great resource, and we went to see some of the things that they've done along Berry Brook. And if you're not sure where Berry Brook is, and I didn't know where it was, if you're exiting Hannaford onto Central Avenue,
yeah,
Berry Brook is that swath right in front of you. They're building this. They're developing something off to the right. But Berry Brook and all of the water handling stuff that they've done is along the swath,
huh,
that is there and some of the streets. And it handles, I don't know how many acres of impervious runoff.
Oh,
I mean, they said so. It's fascinating. And so it was good for. So it was a field trip. You know, we actually saw some of the things, and
yep,
so it was
great.
And Paul Casalt has also been at many of these meetings. He's on the stormwater committee.
Yep.
All right, so that's it for that. You talked about RAC, you talked about, okay, I think we're done, so we can go right to building permits.
First thing we have is an occupancy permit for 27 Wentworth Street.
All right.
Oh, that's right, right? First building permit is 2017-119. 43 Woods Run. They're doing some electrical work, and in addition, they put on a previous permit. The $90 fee has been reviewed by Mr. Clark. Next permit we have is 2017-121. It is 224 Summersworth Road. It's for a sign, a business sign. Mr. Turgeon.
Oh.
Well, Brian Turgeon owns the property, so half the sign is going to be for Turgeon Dust Excavation, or excavating, and other side will be for Dan Pepin's automotive repair. This was discussed at the planning board meeting, at the end of the meeting, for Mr. Pepin. We thought he was there for, as an abutter. We didn't realize that he was there for any new business. But anyway, so we did take care of him. They want to put up a sign. There's been an existing business there. It's in the industrial zone.
So there isn't any issue associated with zoning. So that particular use.
And according to Mr. Krebs, he said that he thought it was fine because there's an existing use there. So.
All right. So now all we have to. So now the question is does the sign follow our signage?
Correct.
That's the question.
So Tom has looked at it?
Tom has reviewed it.
Huh?
Tom reviewed it, yes.
Oh, okay.
And did the fee for it, but he has, I think what's, some of this is, I think Tom's handwriting, I think some of this is the church's handwriting, so. They'd like it as close to the road as the town permits. Give me a second, and I'll find your ordinance on signs, I'm taking a moment. Number of signs there.
Do you think you want to start doing inspections there?
Say that again?
He wants to do car inspections.
He wants to be able to do inspections.
And in order to do them, the state requires him to have a sign.
Right.
Yeah.
But he's just coming here, we're just hearing this for the first time, and I'm thinking to myself, well, you know, do, can I just open up an automotive place at my, you know what I mean, is it zoned for this?
You may not, just do it anywhere you want, no.
That was the first question. So that was my first question, and Jody and I are looking at,
I would give you.
He's looking at us, and we had no clue, so.
Why a number of us have been concerned for a number of years that there is an illegal garage on Clement Road.
Mm-hmm.
But I won't pick that scab right now.
Oh, please do.
When are your books coming in?
Not soon enough, really. Is the answer to that question. It's embarrassing, I'm sorry, but it's,
no, it
there is a sign, section 10. I know, I got that. Okay, one sign displaying this. Oh, this is for a residential district, that's not a residential district. Commercial and industrial districts. We show now temporary or permanent special promotion signs, banners, streamers, or placards. Okay, that's not applicable. On each lot in the commercial industrial zone, there's a permitted one sign affixed to the exterior of a building for each occupant. The top there, the sign permitted for commercial district should not be more than 100 square feet area per sign. In commercial industrial districts where buildings are set back 40 feet or more, which would be the building I believe that Mr. Pepin is going to be working in, one freestanding sign per lot is permitted. So they're suggesting they want to share a sign, top edge of which should not be any higher than 25 feet. But the real thing is we want to know how far away from that. Okay, any such freestanding sign may be located within the front yard space of any such lot, but not nearer than 12 feet from the lot. Okay. So,
are you thinking that Tom didn't look at that?
He reviewed it, but there's no note on here that tells them that it needs to be 12 feet from 12 feet from the from the lot line. So I'm going to indicate it on their building permit. Okay. So we're all on the same page.
$8 an hour.
So they didn't say that they were going to put it within 12 feet of the lot.
Correct.
Oh, okay. Should have been now.
Whatever. Sign must be at least 12 feet from lot line. It may not be taller than 25 feet. Please see zoning ordinance 10.2 for additional requirements.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll have that covered, let's be honest. The real question was whether or not it was permissible in that zone. And whether they had to go through any kind of site review, blah, blah, blah. They will not, so.
So we missed you, Michael, because we couldn't, you know, we just said, oh, no, no, no.
I apologize. I mean, I should have been thinking that I should have
The sign was the last, again, it was not the first question that haunted our minds.
Right. Well, that's good. That's a good thing. Right? We've been trained, you know, anything commercial, we need to talk to the planning board. So. Okay, so the next permit doesn't have a number, and that says it needs a permit number on here. Please and thank you from Tom, I think. I don't know, but it's lot 9 at Scout Landing, 30 Wentworth Street. They are putting in a gas fireplace, or they'd like to. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. I don't know, they must have used an old building permit and they just whited out the number.
So that's not going to help Andrea?
Not at all.
So that has to go to Andrea.
Why?
It has to be logged in.
Just to get logged in.
It just gets signed.
So if we sign it and just say, sign a number, and maybe the minutes can reflect that we sent it for number assignment, you can put it in brackets afterwards that this is the number it's going to sign.
I'll send Andrea an email to a reminder to go see Tom about the building permit.
For 30 Wentworth Street.
Because that's what Chad looked by as well, those two.
It's $90.
$90.
Yeah, it kind of goes.
Did I have to check the permit brand? I can check that out. And that's the last one. I believe, yes. So one in a number, but besides that, we'll check it out.
I have a question on that 121 with the sign. Does lot line mean from the road in?
No, it means from.
Because I think that was their question. Was they wanted as close to the road as possible?
As close as they can get to the road would be 12 feet from their lot line, which would be, we have our right of way, or the state has their right of way, because it's a state road, right? And that's whatever that, you know, it's, I don't know what the state right of way is on Somerville Road. So, and so from there, that'd be 12 feet back. That's what it would have to be. They can't have it right on the edge of the road.
So their property line does not include our right of way?
The state's right of way. I don't believe so, but.
Because usually a right of way denotes that it's someone owns the property. You just have the right to use it.
Yeah, so the state's right of way would probably be like, what, a foot or two? So it'd have to be at least.
I don't know. I think we're trying to figure out is, are we clear enough in that?
Well, I'll make a note.
This is the one without the number.
That's right, part of it.
This, no, I don't think so. This, over here.
I can tell you, there's probably a definition.
State is right away 50 feet from the middle of the road.
Okay. Lot line front. A line dividing a lot from the street. On a lot bounded by more than one side by a street boundary that is to be the lot front shall be so designated. And yeah, that's the total thing. Except for, doesn't say. Let's see what the right of way says. Doesn't say.
I know.
Doesn't say. We don't have a right of way in definition, so. Go back to section 10, make sure it doesn't spell it out specifically. To any lot line, so they have their. Mr. Turgeon has his. Owns the lot. He's the one who's making the application. He must know the dimensions of his lot.
Okay, so 12 feet to any lot line.
So it's, if they're putting it in the front, whatever his lot line is, I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. Where his lot line is, so I don't know if I can't be any clearer. I'm sorry.
Yeah. No, that's clear. All right, correspondence?
No. Sure.
Take everything good.
Okay.
Continental Paving is notifying us of all their paving they're about to do.
Haven't they done it?
Yeah.
They've done it all.
Do they do a nice drawing?
Yes, it looks nice.
Rollins Road looked nice, they weren't rolling it. It didn't look nice when I was stuck in traffic the other day, whatever.
Oh, actually, I was on it.
It was silly enough to go that way.
Yeah, according to this letter, they're starting today.
Wow, fine.
So.
Hold it for them.
Throwback Brewery, approval request for Throwback Brewery to attend the Winter's Farmers Market on several dates, November, December, January, February, and March.
Sounds familiar.
Yeah, we signed it last year too. We appreciate the opportunity to participate in these winter markets, please sign below to indicate your approval. So we did this for them last year as well.
There's no fee? All right, so is the board fine with my signing this? Okay, well, so do. So sign.
Greenhouse.
State requires them to.
Get our approval.
Get approval. And then they have to get a, I think they have a temporary liquor license that they get.
Throwback.
Throwback Brewery.
Throwback.
They're in Northampton.
Yeah, we must have had some kind of email correspondence last year because she shows up in my.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I did something recently and I got this Annette Lee popped up and I said, I wonder who that is.
Well, you know.
Is she?
Citizens Bell, Mike to look at.
Oh, yeah, so this is the.
You already signed it?
Yeah, I authorized it, it's the.
The credit card?
Credit card, yeah. It's just Caroline and some supplies and actually one of them. So we've been sending out our tax bills on printed, you know, return email printed envelopes, which costs us money.
Yeah.
So in there is a bunch of envelopes that are just with glass with windows. So the address and the return, our return address, so we won't have to pay for specially printed envelopes for tax.
See that.
So that's a savings.
Yeah, that's great.
Okay, all right.
Sorry, this is a letter to go out to 220-230 Clement Road. Jeremy Smart and Select Board has been appraised of falling activity, installation or removing of propane tank. The above activity requires a building permit. Please come to the town hall to file a building permit. However, please understand that this may not be possible to process the building permit application due to ongoing compliance matters of the property location.
All right, so we're saying that you need a building permit, but we may actually.
Likely deny it, so.
We might have to deny it because there are outstanding issues.
So you shouldn't really be doing any work up there, is the point of the letter, right?
Yes, would you like to read it before I sign it, actually?
I mean, I.
I know you have a keen interest, comment.
220-230.
Okay. Okay, and there's one here for similar, but it's for paving. But it also says that driveways, this is on 720 Portland Avenue. And the letter also says that, please note, the driveway paving on a state road requires a permit from the Hampshire Department of Transportation. Mm-hmm. So,
my question on that is, it's a new construction. Wouldn't that have been in their building permit?
No, not necessarily. I don't know, but they would tell us.
Okay.
So, you know, just yeah, absolutely.
It's the new red.
It's
building.
The you know, the gentleman came in. He was building it for his daughter, and he had
oh,
an issue about it. You know, he could only fit it.
Right. It was
a tiny
very
quarters
tiny
because
lot.
Of wetlands
yeah,
behind.
It's,
so it's closer to Ed Jansen than my side of Portland Avenue.
Yes. So I know exactly what you're talking about.
Ed's side of
it's
the road.
It's a very peculiar
too.
Lot.
Yeah.
Peculiar lot. Yeah. It has not been paved for since they put it in. They put it in what, last year, the year before last? So
mm-hmm.
I would think it needs one, but.
So we good point.
Yeah.
Because even if it were, at the very least he would have had to have come in for an extension of his building from there.
Oh yeah.
Because we're beyond, yeah.
Well beyond.
Well beyond. Good point.
It's been a couple of years now, I think.
This was by email from Tom Clark today to the New Hampshire DES to the interim superintendent of the school. Site facility is the Rollinsford Grade School with the DES site number reference. Intent to red tag, letter of deficiency. Dear Superintendent Brown, the letter contained important information that aspects the continued operation of the subject facility. If you do not correct deficiency number one as described below within 10 days of this letter, non-compliant UST systems will subject to be red tagged by DES.
So it's a tank.
It's a storage tank of some kind.
Yeah, it's for the fuel.
For stormwater, I thought it said.
Yeah, so we're just copied it. We don't have to do anything, it's just.
I know, I read it at first, I thought it said Tom said you should take action. I'm like, what? But I read it again, like, it's just cool. I read his email again, says you don't need to take any action.
So.
Just an FYI, like.
Just an FYI.
Right, yeah.
So I assume the school will be managing this.
I would hope.
Do you want to know what the red tag deficiency is? Here, red tag deficiency number one. I read it today.
I mean, I read it.
Failure to divert water away from sumps.
Sump pumps, right?
During the April inspection, the DES inspector determined that the stormwater is directly flowing into the STP pump sump. And via 407:06 requires stormwater runoff from underground storage tank facilities shall not be discharged to the subsurface. Where are these things?
So, I don't know, but they can't be new. So, I don't know.
So.
This is a school board's problem, I don't know.
I don't know where the tanks are, so. Rollinsford Cemetery Trustees proposed budget.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
They're looking for $19,000.
Yes, it's exactly the same as last year's, with the exception of that $1,000 that he said put it in as a placeholder. Hopefully we can do something other than that, but at least it's in. So I'm just gonna leave it here because I took that note of that.
Okay. Purchase order. Move to accept purchase order 1285 to FSCF excavation for cemetery. One truckload of 3/4 crushed gravel for cemetery roadways for a total of $359.72.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 And who's it to?
Hussey.
Hussey, yes. Okay, I just need to.
So this is our contract with Atlantic Recycling for our two containers that we approved last week. Todd got this out to us for a total of $11,800. I'm not sure if we signed a purchase order last week or not.
We did that.
Did we? We
so this is just the contract associated
that's
with
the contract
it. So this actually is, I don't think we knew the shipping, because
mm-hmm.
I think our purchase order was for $11,300.
Okay.
So,
and this is contained for the Moore article?
Yes.
Well, it's going to jump it over by a few hundred dollars. So
that's
the bulk of it's coming from the Moore article.
Okay.
And this will pretty much extinguish the balance of the Moore article. And I think the shipping, maybe not quite all of the shipping, but some of it will have to come to the operating budget. So I know that we did the purchase order, but let's have a motion to sign the quote from Atlantic Recycle to accompany that purchase order for $11,800.
So moved.
So.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
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 Our health trust information came in. Overall, it's a 8% decrease in medical coverage. And there's some other information in here that we should probably get out to our employees. They have a convenient MD option for free flu shots, CVS maintenance choice, and things that they can use on their prescriptions.
Yeah, I think that Caroline, hopefully, I think Caroline has, those who want to be signed up for their Primex, because I know I even get stuff from them and hear about all of these things, so hopefully we can always also have her posted on the the employee bulletin board.
Short-term disability reduced by 7.6%. Long-term disability reduced by 15%.
That must be just a general thing. I don't think we use them. Do we use them?
For members currently participating.
Sorry?
For member.
Right, I don't think we participate.
We don't participate for them, for the, are they just our medical?
Yes, because.
I know promise this liability and property.
I think that our life insurance and our disability comes from somewhere else.
Okay. Then I'll stop.
Yeah, it comes from Boston.
Yes, yeah, yes, yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's right. Thank you, Michael.
So we're not, so.
Well, that went out of nowhere.
That's really very good.
Yeah.
So, these are arguments for Rollins.
Yes, and Carol, I did send them to me via email, so I've already got them worked into the budget.
Let me see.
Yeah, there you go.
Didn't,
Yeah, well, yes, I did, so probably the board did.
Yes, great, yes.
Yeah, so. So, Primex also came in. Theirs is an increase, though.
There's a 7% increase, but I'm just kidding.
No, it was very small, I think. I don't think it's huge.
3%.
There you go.
And we budgeted initially, when I first did the budget, I did 9%. You might have been there, Jerry wasn't there. Because that's the cap that we had signed last year. So I said, okay, so now I've reduced it. Yeah, I reduced it.
Yeah, workers' compensation as well. And unemployment compensation.
So in this folder, if you want to see any of this?
So, and everything else in the folder is old from last week or following week, so.
We also got the municipal association increase, which was maybe 2%, 2.5%. And the Stratford Regional Planning was less, it was like $40 or $49.
Right.
So those are in the budget.
Certainly got our due for it, I think.
I think in both of those.
Okay.
Both of those every year, I think. All right, anything else?
That was it.
All right, excellent. So community input? Okay. There's also a budget, there is a budget committee, can I just, I'm sorry, I will get back to you, very, very sorry. There is a budget committee meeting on Wednesday, quarter three review.
Okay.
6:30, right, 6:30.
That's why the historical committee will be meeting in the.
Uh-huh, in the small room.
The side room.
Salma?
Yeah, I was wondering, how long, do we know how long it takes the building inspector to review a septic plan? I mean, if he figured $50, perhaps he was doing it based on how much time he spends. And then if you're cutting that in half, then who's paying for it?
Well, I mean, it's a good question. I don't know the answer to either of those questions. I mean, we do pay him an hourly rate. And he is the one who suggested the $50.
I'm gonna ask him again, just to be safe, I guess.
Well, we've already, you know. The question is, do we want to revisit it? Do we want to table what we just, the fee that we just instituted? Because we did vote on it earlier today.
We can always go back and change it if we have to. I think just leave it the way it is.
Yes.
Going back to the fees, on the electrical, you charge $90. In the same case in point, how long does it take him to go through the electrical? I mean, it's.
Well, that's a physical inspection, though. He's going out to look.
Mm-hmm.
So it's different. He's driving a car, he's taking a look. The septic is not the same. So, is it still worth $50? Probably. I mean, I don't know. That's what he recommended, but you know. Fees are not perfect. They're there to sort of approximate, you know, roughly what we think it costs. So, but I agree, we've done it. We've got the $25. We can always check back in with him. But that's, we'll start
there. Well, you've been doing it. We haven't charged anything, so.
Exactly.
Right.
This is better than what we've been doing.
Yep.
Do we have to have a hearing on it?
No. No.
Just checking.
There's no ordinance. So, all right, anything? Anything else? Oh boy, Monday Night Football.
Yay.
Only an hour behind.
All right. By consensus, we're going home.
Yeah.
All right.
Thanks.